Flash premiered this week. And, well, just for a starting joke, Flash Day...
The flashlight.
Here's the thing with Flash Day. Green Arrow saves Starling City 3 times and he gets jack squat. You'd think by now they would have a Green Arrow Day, knowing this universe.
Yes.
But no, this was the episode with Flash Day. It takes place like 6 months after the first season.
Yep.
And I'm a little mad about that. Because here's the thing. I honestly feel like they have a different set of writers this time. I feel like the Flash writers from last season moved on to Legends of Tomorrow. And now we have Arrow Season 3's writers here.
Yeah.
Because like now they're starting the flashbacks things, kind of like Arrow, and I'm kind of disappointed by that because Flash was doing so well just as the Flash, being its own thing, and it's like now we're getting into Flash's version of the Arrow a little bit with these flashbacks and stuff.
Yeah.
Like, there were some flashbacks in Season 1, don't get me wrong. But I feel like the whole wormhole thing, that's going to be like Oliver Queen being in China or like being...
I don't know if it'll go that far back, but yeah.
But you know what I mean, right? It just seems like that's how they're treating it.
Yeah, to get you caught up.
Yeah.
The thing that kind of bugged me a little bit too is when they were giving him the key to the city... Can we go to this far yet or no?
Well, I just want
a little bit on that.
Well, you can get right to that, but all I wanted to say was Joe West now has the Metahuman Task Force with Cisco now. Yep. Caitlin is in Mercury Labs. Barry now works alone. And again, mad about that, right?
Yeah.
It gets resolved by the end of the episode.
True.
But it's like, why break them up? Why even suggest that they were broken up for a bit? Because I get it, right? Again, of course, this is kind of spoilery talk. That's why I put the timestamps and said, skip it if you didn't watch it.
Yeah.
You know, Ronnie dies trying to stop the wormhole thing.
Yeah.
And it's like, really? You're taking the blame for that?
Yeah. He never got any credit. He got the key to the city and never said, you know, I did do this by myself. I had help.
Yeah, and like also, too, you know, I forget what his name was. Iris's boyfriend that was the ancestor of Wells.
Yeah, I know.
I forgot his name too. But it's like, really? You're taking the blame for 2 deaths?
Yeah.
I mean, the first time, compared to Arrow, you were doing a great job.
Yeah.
Because, like, Tommy died in Season 1 of Arrow. Then you had everyone that he killed. You know, so, but knowing, like, comic book tropes, Ronnie's going to be back. Knowing comic book tropes, Ronnie is going to be back, no matter what.
He was gone before and came back, and so.
Yeah, they're just going to pull that card out again.
Yeah.
You mentioned they had the whole kind of...
I mean, he went into a black hole.
Yeah.
Who's to say they can't come back from the black hole?
Yeah.
So.
You know, and there's a thing, too, where, like, Robbie Amell saying, oh, I want to pitch this Batman Beyond movie and things like that, and he's, like, pushing for that. And I get the feeling, like, yeah, he has a little bit of a break for a while now, but he's going to be back on either Flash or Legends of Tomorrow.
Yeah.
So, but, you know, after we kind of have that Flash Day thing, well, it's kind of during the Flash Day thing, we meet the, kind of, like, one of the new, kind of, like, throwaway villains, where it's like villain of the week thing, which was the Atom Smasher,
mm-hmm.
which he looked so much like Bane to me.
Yeah, he did.
Like, the helmet was different, but like, it just looked like he was Bane from The Dark Knight Rises.
Yeah.
If, you know, when he had his helmet off, and it's like, oh gosh, borrowing some costumes much, DC?
Yeah. They could have made him green for the Incredible Hulk, you know, without the angriness, but, you know, I just kind of like swelled up.
Yeah. Then, like, don't get me wrong, I kind of liked the villain, but he's kind of like, if you remember the episode with Emily Kinney when she played the scientist with the robotic bees, I feel like they used him as much as they did her, where it's just like, minor convenience.
Yeah.
You know, just to get the team back together and things like that. I gotta say... This too, Wells confesses to the death of Nora Allen.
Yeah.
Which I think we all kind of saw that coming eventually.
Yeah, I didn't see the whole dad leaving thing.
Yeah, that was something that was like,
I mean, here,
really.
Yeah, here, I mean, you've been locked away for 15 years, and mm-hmm. then your son finally gets you out of prison and say, I'm leaving on the next train. Don't know when I'll be back again. Unless you need me.
Yeah.
You know, it's like,
I wonder if they're, like, I wonder if it's just like he had other jobs or if he had
some
family life.
In prison.
No, I'm talking about the actual actor.
Yeah, I don't know.
Like, if he had like a family life that he wanted to pay more attention to and things like that. So that's why they wrote that in. Not sure. But it's nice to know that he's free now.
Yeah, it just doesn't make sense that he's leaving.
Yeah, but again, that's, like I said, it's probably just because of something with the actor. Okay, a lot of people were torn on this. I was laughing at, you know, the Batman fan that I am, at the flash signal.
Flashlight. I call it the flashlight.
The flashlight. That's actually a lot better than the flash signal. But, I mean, like, I don't know, like, you know, because Arrow steals a lot from Batman, it's like, yeah, that didn't work a lot in Arrow, you know, but especially season 3. But here, it works perfect.
Yeah, it was funny.
And I love it how Cisco says that
he saw it in a comic book,
and it's like,
I think I saw it in a comic book.
Yeah, it's kind of sad that it's like, okay, Batman's not going to exist in this universe, period. But I love the little mention towards it.
Yeah.
I don't think we've ever had a live-action Batman show that, or like any live-action DC show where they had Batman in it, besides the Adam West show in the 60s.
I think that was it.
So, I wish they would have left it open that way they could have Batman in there somewhere, just in case of like the DC Cinematic Universe fails or something.
Yeah.
That way they could just move it all to the TV universe. I feel like that would have been great. We figure out, you know, the new evil speedster is named Zoom,
yeah.
This season. I didn't look it up, but apparently in Canada they released who he is.
Oh.
I got on a promotional thing, so I may bring that up for next week.
Okay.
If they don't show him off next week. The new emblem on the suit looks great.
Yeah, I like
it. I love the white emblem.
Yeah.
It's just, I can't wait to see the part where, like, he runs back in time in order to stop his old self from, doing the whole, don't kill him thing. I feel like that will be kind of cool to see. I always thought that the logo looked a little weird with the red background and the gold. So I'm glad that we actually got to, get that white piece. I think in, if we're going by, like, Arrow standards here, season 4, he'll have, like, the brighter costume, and
mm-hmm.
it will look a lot cooler. But, again, I love the white emblem. It looks great on the suit.
Yeah.
And then Jake Garrick shows up for the end of the episode.
The original Flash, right?
He's the first Flash.
First Flash.
From the comics, which, his origin is kind of sad. I mean, because, like, not like, oh, that's depressing, but it's like, really? All he did was spilled some hard water onto some chemicals. The chemicals blew up, and then he just got superpowers. And it's, there's no like lightning or anything like that. It's just, oh, I spilled some water that had a high mineral count into some chemicals, and boom, I'm the Flash.
At least it could have been like toxic sludge or something.
Maybe not toxic sludge, since that's overused. Gamma radiation.
Yeah.
Just something a little different. But they haven't really explained the origin for their version.
Yeah,
you never know what they're going to do with it. I think it's going to be kind of the alternate universe type thing, which I didn't put it in my notes here, but at the beginning it seemed like there was an alternate universe that they kind of started, but they never touched up on.
Yeah.
Where the boyfriend was still alive. I'm always going to forget his name.
In the beginning of the thing, I got confused.
And then Wells was alive, and he stood up and, shook Barry's hand. So it's like, I think that's an alternate universe.
Yeah.
And I think that's how they're going to get Harrison Wells back into the show, is they're going to find a way to get him into this universe, and then we'll have the Harrison Wells again, or some sort of time travel thing.
Yeah.
But it's more likely to have the alternate universes, and I'm going to steal a joke that I saw online. There's a picture of the CW Flash, And then it shows, like, all these fractals behind him, and it says, Crisis on Infinite Earths. And it shows Keaton's Batman and all the other DC movies and TV shows from, like, the past years. And it's like, if they found a way to do that, that would be amazing, to do that kind of storyline with all the old DC superhero actors and stuff. I think that would be cool. But, you know, it's a good start to the season. Don't get me wrong.
Yeah.
I don't think it's as strong as last season. Like,
last season
was incredible, and I don't blame them, but it's just like, this season didn't seem like it was, or this premiere didn't seem like it was up to par to, like, kind of the last episodes that they had, and that's why I think they swapped writers, was because, you know, I feel like they're gonna just keep moving that team of writers that wrote Arrow Season 2, that also wrote Arrow, or Flash Season 1, I think they're just gonna move them around to all the new projects that they're... that they're going to be working on.
Get the big, draw.
Yeah. And, like I said, I'm not a big fan of the flashbacks thing with the wormhole. I feel like they should have just left that and, like, picked up right where they left off and then had it so it's, like, a couple episodes after that. Yeah, like, three episodes or something like that.
Yeah, it kind of gives you... I don't think from now on they're going to keep on going back to that.
You never know, though.
Yeah. So, I think they just did that to get people, this is where we left off, and then they're going to keep on going forward. That's what I'm hoping for.
Yeah, if it does turn into Arrow, I'm going to be disappointed. But, you know, it does feel like the writing's a little bit weirder this season.
Yeah.
And
like you said, the whole foreshadowing of maybe...
alternate universes. You know, there's also... They also casted Wally West, so we're going to have that in there somewhere. Because Wally West is going to be the Kid Flash.
Kid Flash, okay, yeah.
Which it seems like they're going with New 52 style since, we know the West family already. If you saw season one of Flash, they're not white and with red hair and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Like in the original run of the comics. But, I feel like they're still going to do good. I mean, I keep saying Arrow because I'm thinking Arrow's next, right? Arrow's... Like, here's the way that we film this is we film it the day after. So, like, the day after it comes out.
Yeah.
So, Arrow's tonight.
Yeah.
And I'm psyched for that. But we're talking about Flash, so it's like, whatever. But like I said, I feel like this is a really good start. It's got a lot of good questions for me, like, what's Jay Garrick doing here? Like, we saw his helmet at the end.
Yeah.
They showed kind of pictures of his costume. His costume, besides the helmet, doesn't look that good. It just seems like kind of like one of those raincoat type of costumes. And it's like, okay, for Golden Age, that kind of makes sense. But couldn't we just update it a little bit? But like I said, it's going to be amazing to see where we go with it. Because now there's four speedsters in the season. We're going to have, you know, alternate dimensions. We're going to have all this other stuff. And, you know, there's still the stuff that they foreshadowed to at the end of Flash Season 1, where Caitlin Snow will turn into Killer Frost, and Cisco will turn into his own superhero.
Yeah.
And they kind of showed that again this episode with his vibrations.
Well,
they're kind of
showing, too, Cisco's powers in this episode, too, which was...
Yeah, that's cool. What I was talking about with the seeing the vibrations.
Yeah, so that was kind of neat.
Yeah, this is going to be a very interesting season.
Yeah. I think I'm going to be heartbroken, though, when she turns into
Killer Frost. I don't think they're going to do that this season, though.
Yeah.
Here's the thing. I don't think they're going to do that this season. If they did, it would make sense because, you know, Ronnie died and things like that, and it would kind of mess with her psyche and stuff like that, you know, to see that she's getting powers now and now she may have the same fate that he did and blah, blah, blah. You know, I think that would be kind of cool, but... I think that's going to happen later on. That way they can cross over with Supergirl when it comes out. Because Killer Frost is also a Superman villain.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
so
that makes sense.
If they did it, like, say, season 3 of Flash, where Supergirl is season 2, you know, it will be easier to do, and, you know, she'll be crossing over. Hopefully CBS will let her cross over. It seems like they're in the same universe, that thing. Except for the whole thing where, like, Superman has been there for a while now, even though, like, Arrow already set up. No, there was no one besides the Arrow before it. No one with powers anyways. So it's like, that's going to be a little iffy to explain, but either way, we're kind of getting off track. Flash season 2 premiere, pretty good.
Yeah, I liked it.
I liked it too.
Yeah.
Like I said, it's not as strong as Arrow season 1, but Flash season 1. Damn it. Yeah. You know, it's not as strong, but it's still good.
Yeah, excellent.
They still got the writing down. I just feel like Flash is a little easier to write for. You know what I mean? Because Flash, like, you're... the story is... like, they're not writing it, trying to write it as a Batman story, but put Green Arrow into it. Mm-hmm. Flash is having his own stories that, yes, feel kind of like Spider-Man. I've always kind of thought that, you know, Flash was kind of like the Spider-Man show that, you know, Marvel never really had when it came to live action. There was a Japanese live action Spider-Man. That turned into like Power Rangers and stuff like that later. Mm-hmm.
I think too they're gonna bring Grodd back.
Grodd, yeah.
Grodd.
I want to see him again.
And because they thought, well, maybe that was, you know, the Atom Crusher was him.
Yeah.
And but the only thing I was confused on, or not really confused. Did they still have the containment where they have all the other villains? So did the Atom Crusher go in there, or...?
I believe so.
Because they didn't... I didn't really see him showing that...
They didn't show that, so but I assume that that's where they're holding them still.
Yeah.
So yeah, I think that's it for me. I think that's all I got on it. So, Flash Season 2, Episode 2... Barry has a new "My name is Barry Allen" speech, and there is no way I am going to remember this one, just like the last one.
Yeah.
There is no way that I ever...
He is the fastest man, though.
Yeah, he is. And there's no way that I'm going to remember his whole speech. But...
By the 12th episode, we should have it done.
Well, half of it. I still don't know all of, like, the Arrow ones or anything like that. So, then we learn right out of the bat of the episode, Jay Garrick is from another world, Adam Smasher was from that same world,
yep.
And Zoom is from that same world.
Correct.
We also learn that Jay Garrick lost all of his speedster abilities, but there's still some regeneration, they said.
Yeah.
So, that has happened. And I want to know what your thoughts were on the Jay Garrick suit.
I didn't like it. It was like World War II,
you know. Well, World War One, really.
World War One, yeah. Yeah, probably World War One, yeah. Not World yeah,
World War One, probably World British War forces.
I. Yeah.
Kind of look. Here's the thing. I don't mind the helmet, because that's right in the comics. That's right from the comics.
Yeah.
The thing that I wish that they would have changed was, I wish it was brighter in color. I feel like it would have looked nicer if it was in color.
It looked because, like a World War One uniform with a hat.
Yeah, because like if they brightened up the colors a little bit, you would have saw the lightning bolt a little better. You would have
didn't even see that.
Yeah, you would have saw, you know, the red and yellow contrast a little bit better. If they would have had that, I feel like the suit would have looked nice. But I see, like, I get it. They're trying to go for it's like their version of the Flash costume. That's same nice color scheme, call things like that.
Yeah,
so you know, but I wish that it was a little brighter, and I feel like it would have made sense because it is an Elseworld.
Yeah.
Or alternate universe type thing, so it would be like, well, in this universe, they actually have color in their superheroes.
Yeah, well, I mean, the alternate world, too, could be, like you said, from an older time.
So, yeah.
You know, maybe cars was new to him. You guys got cars in this, you know? So.
Well, he said that it was his father's suit from the War of the Americas.
Yeah, so that would be World War, so yeah.
Besides that, I kind of like it. I kind of like the look of it.
Yeah,
it's just the coloring is off for me.
It didn't really do anything for me.
Let's see here. We get to see Zoom for the first time.
Yeah.
And yeah, he's doing his reverse Flash thing.
Yeah, with the whole vibrating thing.
Yeah, he's pretty much the reverse Flash, but with a helmet, and he's blue.
Was it blue or black?
I think he was blue.
Was it blue?
He was a navy blue.
Alright, yeah. Very dark.
Very dark in color.
Yeah.
Pretty much doing the whole Harrison Wells thing. Even with the voice, it sounded like it was Harrison Wells.
Yeah. And my theory is that it's Harrison Wells' alter ego.
Oh, that would be funny if it's Harrison Wells from the alternate universe.
Yeah.
It's like every time we go up against a new speedster, they're just going to believe that's Harrison Wells.
That's what I'm thinking.
That would be so funny, but I really wish they wouldn't do that.
But I think they're going to.
Probably. Because, like...
I mean, if this guy's supposed to be like Barry, you know, Barry...
Barry,
it's going to be the same thing.
Also, too, Jay Garrick's backstory, pretty much the same. Spilt some hard water and then became a superhero.
Yeah.
I always thought that his kind of origin story was a little weak.
Hydrogen bomb? That kind of theory?
No. Okay. Pretty much his whole thing is he dropped water with a higher mineral count.
Yeah.
And then became the Flash.
So
I always thought that was kind of like, big because at least Barry got struck by lightning.
Yeah.
During that. And there was a particle accelerator. Jay Garrick, it was just like, oh, he dropped some hard water. Chemicals exploded. Now he's the Flash.
Yeah. But water is hydrogen and two parts oxygen.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
But so this one has more minerals.
So if he's taking out the oxygen, then you got nothing but hydrogen to cause the explosion. Therefore, like, hydrogen bomb.
But where does the Flash part of that come through?
From the big... Saw a big light from the explosion itself.
Okay.
Could be.
But how cool does it sound when you say, oh yeah, I dropped hard water and then I became a superhero?
Yeah.
It's like saying, oh, I spilled this Mountain Dew over some chemicals and then now I have super speed for some reason. Okay. I've never really found like that version of the origin story to be interesting. I've always found that Barry's was a little cooler because of, you know, the lightning, the particle accelerator, things like that. Okay, and also too, when they're explaining the alternate universe, they mentioned Earth 2.
Oh.
I love that.
Yeah.
Because Earth 2, for those who don't know, is an actual DC, like, thing. Right? They call it... I think they actually do call it Earth 1 for their primary universe. I think New 52, they may have renamed that to something else, but I don't know. And then Earth 2 is where Thomas Wayne Batman is from. It's pretty much like the... I think it's like the Golden Age, pretty much. All the Golden Age comics. And then a couple of different alternate universes. Don't quote me on that. But yeah, like, if it is from the same universe as Thomas Wayne Batman, oh god. Because Thomas Wayne Batman was the one that carried guns around and killed people. And then in the new 52 comics... He took a pill that would give him superpowers.
Okay.
So, I wonder if it's just that universe or the Golden Age. I'm thinking it's more Golden Age universe. So, like, the 60s, 70s comics.
Okay.
We got introduced to a new character.
Okay.
Patty Spivot.
Spivot, yeah.
And it looks like she will be Joe's partner in the future, kind of replacing Eddie.
Yeah.
She's like a combination of Barry's forensic science and Joe's kind of police officer thing.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I didn't like her too much. It's just like, she's kind of there type thing with me. But I bet she'll get better throughout the season.
Yeah.
I
don't know if they're trying to pull her off as like a Felicity where she's like the nerdy... The cute nerdy girl, but also extremely smart.
I hope that they don't, because that's kind of,
yeah, so I mean...
They're kind of already doing that.
Yeah, so...
With, Caitlin.
So I don't know where they're going.
Yeah.
But I still like her. I got high hopes for her.
I gotta watch a little bit more of her in order to... See if I do or not.
Because when she was talking about the two brothers, was that the freeze guy and the fire
no,
guy?
No, I'll get to that.
Oh, okay, sorry.
Remember, we go in the order of when it happened.
All right, okay.
Then we get to see our new weekly villain, which is Sand Demon. So for you Marvel fans, just pretty much think Sandman, but DC. Yeah. And then we get two scenes of Cisco looking through kind of... He describes it as getting a Vibe, which is his comic book counterpart, is a superhero called the Vibe, and he kind of gets like repulsor powers and stuff like that. And then, but we figure out what his power kind of is. When he touches something, he's able to kind of
foresee the future.
Well, also kind of see the past.
Yeah.
I see it more as, because it seems like every time that he's used it so far, he sees a recent past from it.
Okay, well, he was saying he was seeing what was about to happen, right?
I'm not sure, but when I watched it, I thought, you know, maybe it's because of how they played the scenes. Because, like, when...
Okay, maybe it is the past that he's...
See, because, like, when she's in the chair...
of what was going to happen. Because...
I think maybe that was the first episode when they were doing that. But when Patty... Again, we'll get to it. Well, actually, we can get to it since it's my next point. Sam Demon takes Patty.
Yeah.
So when...
Kidnaps her, yeah.
So when he takes her... That was played, that scene where, you know, she's like, the Flash is going to get you. And he's like, that's the plan or whatever. Yeah. You know, then the scene after that is him touching the sand particles.
Sand particle, yeah.
And then him seeing that exact scene. So that's why I'm thinking he gets to see the recent past.
Okay.
Again, I could be wrong. This is just us watching the show and trying to figure it out, but...
Or it could be, too, that it's at the same time.
Yeah.
They just can't show both things at the same time, otherwise you have to have a split screen.
So yeah.
Could be the same time.
So, yeah. We're not sure yet. We'll probably get more clarity on that in the upcoming episodes and stuff. And then, Flash gets a new ability. He gets the lightning bolts.
Yeah.
So pretty much what he does, he runs really fast.
Static
and
electricity
then
kind of thing.
Takes the
theory.
He takes the lightning from behind him and just chucks it in a direction.
Guides it.
And here's the thing. Barry's a little kill happy this season, I've noticed. Because two out of the two villains we've had, he killed them.
Yeah. I wasn't sure that he killed the first one.
He killed Atom Smasher.
So yeah. And then, yeah, now this guy.
And now, Sand Demon. So
Sand Demon.
I'm like,
yeah.
Maybe he's a little kill happy this season. I don't know. I didn't count up the casualties for season one. I know it was pretty low in season one.
Are the old villas still stored in the...
No, I thought they escaped.
Yeah, I thought they... Yeah. So I don't think there's anybody in there now.
No, I don't think there's anyone in there.
So...
But yeah, like I said, I think... He's killed both of them so far.
Yeah.
Compared to
maybe there's
first
no place
season.
To store them now, so he's got to kill.
No, because they show Jay getting locked up in there because Barry doesn't trust Jay.
Yeah, but he wasn't a metahuman. He was just a normal guy.
Well, he was a metahuman.
Yeah, but I'm just saying maybe the containment can't store metahumans anymore because the accelerator thing's not working.
The accelerator thing never worked.
Okay. Never mind. It had to have power somehow. Because remember when they turned the whole thing blew up or whatever and he ran up the thing? That was all.
Like, it never worked as a particle accelerator.
No,
but it worked for holding them in.
That's what I'm saying. It blew up last season, right? That's what caused the wormhole?
Maybe.
blew it up because.
I don't remember it too well.
Okay.
To be quite honest.
We need help on that one. Can the particle accelerator
still... Well, either way, Iron Heights is set up as a metahuman prison as well now.
Okay. So,
Barry just doesn't need to go, well, we don't have a place to store them. Let's kill them all. And even if that is the fact, that's way out of character for Barry.
Yes.
I think it's more just like kind of accidental things. Because, like, this definitely was an accident where, like, he, like, literally, Sand Demon, when he got hit by it, he, like, flew up in the air and then landed.
Yeah, turned into glass.
So I feel like that was more of kind of, like, one of those accidents. And then,
Well, he knew what was going to happen. He knew he was going to turn to glass.
Yeah, but he didn't know that he was going to get, like, flung back, probably, or anything like that. And then with Atom Smasher, they got him into that containment thing... last episode, and then he kind of got all his power drained away from him.
Yeah, but I didn't think he died.
I thought he did.
Maybe he did.
Again, it's been a week, so...
Yeah.
That's kind of the problem with some of these episodes, where it's like, oh, let's try to think this through, and it's like,
okay.
Whatever. Let's see here, where else are we at?
Of course he's dead.
Yeah. So we learned that Mark Martin, one of the brothers, not Captain Cold and all that. I think it's the first pair of brothers from the Whirlwind guy, and then the was it Weather Wizard? Those two were brothers.
Oh, yeah, the one guy who can control the weather, and then yeah. But the one brother died, and then the other brother that could control the weather.
Weather Wizard is still alive.
Was still alive.
So I think it's one of those two brothers. I don't remember the name, but I remember the nicknames.
Right.
So one of them killed
Spartacus.
So
Andy Whitfield, I think?
Okay. Mark Martin killed Spivet's dad, and that's why she wants to join the task force. And she is now on the task force, so yes. Yay.
Yeah.
So now it's just Joe, Sisko, and Spivet on this task force. No one else.
Yeah.
Maybe Barry.
Well, I think she'll get dragged into the whole
Flash thing. Yeah. I really hope not, because Iris got dragged into it last season. Like, I really liked the kind of person that didn't know.
Yeah.
Type feeling. So hopefully they'll keep that, because otherwise it kind of turns into Arrow, where like everyone knows and then everyone becomes a superhero. Let's see here. We get to meet Iris's mother this episode.
Yeah, what's that all about?
I have no idea.
She left. Oh yeah, that's right. She didn't die. She just left. And now she's back.
Yeah, and I like how she's like, I'm coming back, you know, to meet you and my daughter. And it's like, well, wait until you meet your adopted son.
Yeah.
I feel like that's going to cause drama next episode.
I don't think they needed to be brought in.
Yeah, I don't think so either, but it's just going to be brought in for a little bit of drama and maybe for a little bit of Iris and Barry bonding, since we haven't had that yet this season.
No. And maybe they won't. I don't know. Maybe they could push it off towards the...
Maybe she's the lamb for slaughter somewhere.
Yeah, I don't know.
Who knows? Then Sisko tells the professor about his new abilities and tells him to kind of keep it secret.
Mm-hmm.
I always forget the professor's name.
Yeah, I don't remember.
Just Professor Firestorm. Let's leave it at that.
Yeah.
One half of Firestorm.
I think that's a mistake.
You really think so?
Yeah, I think Sisko should tell him that he's got these powers and to help him. I know he doesn't want to use them, but they could help him not to use them.
Yeah. Like, the thing that I see
if he doesn't want the power or doesn't want to use the powers, they can help him to control the powers so that they're not...
Well, I think, like, the thing is, too, like... Okay. So we all know that he's going to turn into a superhero in the show because of the comics, the vibe. But... we don't know how this is going to pan out. I like this idea where he's trying to keep a secret now, because, like I said, everyone knows who the Flash is that's close to the Flash. So if they don't know that he has this power, I think that would be kind of interesting for the show. But I do agree with you. It's like, they can help you. I mean, they helped Barry. You know, I understand the whole, you know, like, oh, Harrison Wells gave me this power thing, and everyone goes, ah! You know, that kind of thing, or whatever, you know, it's just, it's really kind of weird, but it's also kind of good, too.
Yeah.
Let's see here. And then right at the end of the episode, the professor collapses, and then we cut away to the other universe, where we kind of get a confirmation of Harrison Wells
is coming back,
but he's in another universe.
Yeah. 1991. So it's...
Other universe in 1991.
Yeah, different universe 1991.
So...
or it could be this universe 1991.
Could be. I mean, they never explained that.
So he could be coming back...
From the past. Here's the thing, though, with that. I think they're going to bring him
back because... the same company.
Yeah. Here's the thing. I think they're going to bring him back, but he's going to be replacing the professor, because I think the professor, along with Ronnie Raymond, who I think they already confirmed is in Legends of Tomorrow, I think the professor's going to move into Legends of Tomorrow, and then Wells will take his place again. We'll have the whole Barry, like, I don't trust you type thing, and, like, do Like, I don't want to say he'll be doing, like, a Batman type thing where, like, you know, he picks him up by the neck, throws him up against the wall, and says, "What are you doing here?" You know, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
But I get the feeling that he'll do something like that. You know? And then Harrison Wells will be like, "I have no idea what you're talking about."
Yeah. I'm from a different timeline.
Or you know, he'll never... Yeah. Or maybe he doesn't even know that.
I'm the carpenter in this universe.
Carpenter.
He could be an electrician.
Could be. Could be. So yeah. Overall, this was a great episode of The Flash.
Yeah, I liked it.
And it feels more on track with Flash.
Mm-hmm.
There weren't any flashbacks really in this episode. So I'm glad that they finished that up quickly and made it so it didn't feel like an Arrow season 3 type thing. I was really worried that I was gonna go down that route. But I'm glad that, like, right out of the gate, they're like, "Nope, we're done."
Yeah.
As for Jay Garrick, I like how they integrated him, but I wish we could have saw him as the speedster this episode. Because here's the thing. Harrison Wells was a speedster, but he acted like he wasn't.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like it would have been cool if we had a mentor that was a speedster that was actually teaching Barry along the way.
Yeah.
You know, showing him, you know, this is what you have to do.
Yeah, I don't know.
Instead of just, like, instructing him. You know, I feel like that would have been kind of cool.
Yeah, then you got two speedsters against one villain. That probably wouldn't fly.
Well, maybe do, like, what they did with Power Rangers. Green Ranger limit that shit.
Yeah.
Where it's like, I only have so much power, but I'll be able to show you how to do this.
Yeah.
You know, it won't be a... My version won't be effective, but yours will. You know, that kind of thing. Or just have it so, like, he's half the speed that Barry is.
Yeah.
Or something like that, due to... Like, I would have liked to see him with some power. Or some just, speed.
Yeah. Or show more clips of him, like, when he was saying, okay, I'm going to show you how to do the lightning bolt thing. Well,
show, like, a side-by-side or something.
Or go back in time to when he could do it.
Mm-hmm.
I remember when,
yeah,
you know, I fought him, I did this. And then show him how he fought that scene against him.
Yeah,
he's telling Barry how to do it.
But that may become a little too much like Arrow, if they do it that way.
Well, it's not jumping back in time. Well,
yeah, it is jumping back in time.
Yeah, it is. But I mean, it's...
But it's like the opposite of the, you know, Arrow. It's like, if we had it so all of season 4 was that opening episode, right? Where it's Ollie and Felicity living through their day-to-day lives. They're watching the news... And then Ollie just had flashbacks to when he was the Green Arrow. It would be like something like that. But I really wish that we could have seen Jay Garrick with some sort of speed powers. I think that would have been so interesting.
No.
Instead of just kind of having that kind of Harrison Wells sit behind the computer and talk him through it. You know, having it so he would be able to show him a little bit and maybe even help him in times of need. Besides that, I'm liking Jay so far. I like where his story's going. I'm liking the actor so far.
Yeah, I think he's doing a good job.
I think maybe sometimes his acting's a little off, where it just doesn't seem like he knows exactly what he's saying yet. Because, you know, it's The Flash and everything is so weird in Flash universe. But I think that will get better over time. I mean, I think... Grant Gustin has gotten better throughout the seasons. Or two seasons.
Yeah.
So I think he'll get better. I think Pivot is probably the weakest part of this episode. Because it's like... You're kind of pushing that subplot in when this is kind of like a major plot piece.
Yeah.
And it's like, eh... We could save that for a filler episode. Instead of kind of this big piece where, you know, Jay Garrick is kind of a big part of it and he's kind of, you know, taking up most of the spotlight. But I'm still interested to see what happens with it. I still think that, like, her character will get better throughout the season and we'll see more of it and determine whether or not I like her or not.
Yeah, I think she's going to do good. I think it's going to work out.
Yeah, and I'm interested in seeing where the Cisco storyline goes. I'm interested to see where the main storyline goes. I enjoyed the episode more than the first.
Yeah.
Again, really great episode to kind of lead us off with. I really liked it. Flash Season 2, Episode 3. Man, next week, We won't be starting the show with this. We'll be starting it with Supergirl and then going into this.
Yeah.
So that's going to be a nice change.
Yeah.
I still have to change the banner.
Okay. Yeah, so, right in there.
Yeah. So, Iris starts off the episode by getting shot at. Barry catches her when she jumps out of a window.
Yeah. Cool effect.
Very cool. Shows a little bit of wall running.
Mm-hmm.
You know, kind of gives it that... it kind of felt like a Spider-Man type thing a little bit.
Oh.
Just a little bit.
Yeah.
You know, with the wall running and...
Running up the... Yeah.
Yeah.
So zip lining up the wall. He's running up the wall.
Or crawling up it.
Yeah.
Still a really cool scene, though. They find the wormhole in the basement of Star Labs.
Yep.
And they believe that they can stabilize it in order to send Jay Garrick home.
Mm-hmm.
Then we figure out that Iris's mother has come back. We kind of figured that part out
last episode.
But now we figure out why.
Yeah.
Because she wants to support her daughter because she lost, quote unquote, the love of her life.
Yeah.
How did she know this exactly?
I don't know.
I mean, like...
Yeah, it's...
That's the part I don't understand, is how would she know that information?
Yeah. Yeah, because... Yeah. Well, I guess their engagement was announced in the paper.
It was?
Yeah. So, I mean, she probably saw the engagement announced in the paper.
They put that in the paper?
Yeah, they did put it in the paper.
Oh. Okay.
So, yeah, it was announced that they were, yeah.
Well, you learn something new every day.
Yeah.
Just a pause. What if I just kept this in the show?
It's HQ Salon for...
Oh, then I gotta cut it out.
Okay. Should we just start over or no?
No. We could.
Okay, that's fine. Just cut this part out.
Yeah.
And begin.
3, 2, 1. Sorry, phone went off. Let's see here. Flash is now a coffee.
Yes, double espresso, so all the caffeine and all the sugar and, yeah.
Now, come on now, that's a little too much with the Flash.
Yeah.
We got Flash Day out of the way. We don't need a coffee as well.
So...
Maybe on its 20th anniversary or something. But.
I mean, an energy drink, something that's healthy for you, maybe, but a double espresso coffee with caffeine, it's not good for you.
anyways, yeah, I just thought that was a little weird, because they had that scene with Patty in there. Again, nothing really new with her.
Yeah, are they going to date? Is that the new love interest for
Barry? They don't do too much with that.
Yeah.
So... It's just...
And she's only in the episode.
There for like two scenes.
Yeah.
So. Let's see here. Then Snart's sister runs into Cisco.
Cisco, yeah.
And then says that she needs the Flash's help because Snart... Okay, there's a lot of Snarts this episode.
Yeah.
Captain Cold.
Captain Cold. We'll go through that one.
You know, they thought that Captain Cold was captured.
Yeah.
They tracked down the Cold Gun using science...
Yeah,
like ultraviolet or
kind of because the gun gives off a
a cold signature instead of a heat signature, so they find them that way. Then we figure out that it was kind
of
Well, I was just gonna say it is a trap.
Yeah,
we do see Papa Snart.
Yeah.
Papa
Snart.
Yeah, that's the only way I'm wording it that way. And Barry does escape, but like the way that he escapes is like he gets shot with a cold gun, and then that emblem kind of starts heating up.
Yeah,
that was Cisco's idea. He comes up with a lot of the ideas.
Yeah,
Caitlin's
like
just.
I know you're not a big Cisco fan, but I think Cisco's cool.
Caitlin, like, what does Caitlin do?
She's a doctor, so she does all the monitoring of the with his metabolism, his heart rate, healing.
But she doesn't do anything with the gadgets or anything like that. That's all Cisco's department.
She's a doctor.
Yeah.
So.
Not necessary when, you know, you're regenerating. But it does come in handy every once in a while.
Plus, she's nice to look at, so.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And she was from Sky High.
Yeah.
Don't know if we went over that. Let's see here. We learned that Snart is an abusive father.
That bastard. Sorry.
Like, literally, like, she shows, like, a scar, like, on her shoulder,
when
collar.
When she was 7 years old?
Yeah,
I think.
From a bottle.
Yeah. This is what you get in my house when you're 7 years old. Yeah, that's
awful. That's terrible.
Yeah.
Shouldn't be laughing at that,
no,
but it is terrible.
It's not funny.
And, like, she got the worst end of it.
Yeah. Yeah, because the boys could fight back, so...
Yeah. Well, not just that, but, like, her father didn't like her compared to the brothers.
Yeah.
But we did figure out that, like, Captain Cold does, you know...
He'll do anything to protect his sister.
So... And that's, like, at first, you know, Barry is talking with Cold, but Cold isn't talking back, you know, about this and things like that. So then, you know, it just kind of is like, you know, next time I see you, get out of my face, or, mm-hmm. you know, you'll be blasted with a cold gun, and I'll make sure that it kills you this time.
Yeah.
Then we figure out that Snart's father has a device that literally makes people's heads explode if they have traces of thermite on them.
Yes.
And it seems to have no radius.
No, yeah, just the whole thing explodes. So, headless horseman.
Yeah.
Little pieces here, little pieces there. Oop, I think I stepped in an ear.
Hey, where's your sister? Over there, and up there.
Yes.
So yeah, like, I don't think they gave him, like, a supervillain name.
No, but I kind of like Papa Smark, or Snark.
Let's just call him Papa Smurf.
Yeah, Papa Smurf.
That's his new supervillain name, is Papa Smurf.
Well, he's... Well, say what happened to him yet or
not? Not yet. Okay, let's save that for the end of it.
Okay.
We figure out the only reason why Cold is working with his father is because he's just trying to protect his sister.
Yeah.
We see that Iris's mom is a drug addict.
Drug addict.
Oh, like, we didn't need enough of those in TV media.
You know, why? I mean,
like,
she was dead. Why are they bringing her back? There's no reason in the storyline for her to be here.
Yeah, they don't show any reason behind that.
Yeah.
And, like, I'm tired of shows doing this now, right? It feels like ever since, like, Breaking Bad had, like, the whole huge drug theme.
We need a drug user in this movie, so we're gonna put one in here.
Yeah. I mean, like, Fear the Walking Dead. Do we really need the fucking drug kid? I mean, seriously!
F-bomb. Sorry.
I know. It's just, oh, God.
Yep.
We don't need one.
No.
We don't.
Drugs
no
are
one.
Bad. They're bad.
No one wants to watch that either.
Yeah.
No one wants to watch that.
No.
It's just, oh, God. Let's see here. The Joe and Iris moment where he tells
That was
Iris,
actually touching.
That was really good.
I thought that was
great acting on both of their parts.
Yeah,
too.
I thought that was, I got a little teary-eyed almost.
Yeah, it was really good.
Excellent. Could be the medication that I'm on, but... I'm just kidding. No,
it was
a great
job. Very good.
It was done perfectly. It was very... Yeah.
Yeah.
So...
And, like, here's the thing. Like, she doesn't go, like, all explosive. Why didn't you tell me?
No, yeah, she, yeah.
She's like, I totally understand.
Yeah.
I've seen metahumans. I've seen...
Yeah, she's seen everything.
You know, alternate dimensions... This is just a little bit of a crack in the road.
And it shows, too, how close she is with her dad. And how,
yeah.
You know, so, I mean, that was really cool that they...
That they did that.
That was good. I mean, it didn't have to be that her mom was back. They could have did it another way, but still, it was a good moment.
Let's see here. Then Barry meets up with Snart again. That way he can infiltrate, you know, Snart's...
Oh, the gang.
Gang, yeah.
Yeah.
And that way he can help save Snart's sister.
Mm-hmm. Did they say her name? I can't
Lisa.
Remember. Lisa, that's it.
Yeah, otherwise known as the Golden Glider.
Yes. See, that's my name. Golden Glider. Really cool bike.
Yeah. So, he's successful on getting in, and we get this really cool heist scene. I really liked it.
Mm-hmm.
Did you?
Yeah, I thought it was cool. I liked when he was punching in the keypad.
Yeah, that was cool. I liked how he was able to walk around the whole he has a gun thing.
Yeah.
You know, like... I just love how he was able to stop him from doing that without, you know, like,
killing
pulling the gun away from him or anything like that. That was really well written. Let's see here. We think that Barry gets shot, But then we realize that he doesn't get shot because he caught the bullet.
Caught the bullet.
And then made it look like he actually got shot. So that was cool. Then Sisko has a way to remove the thermite from Lisa, but there's a possibility of blowing both of them up because the gun that he has to kind of take it out has compressed air in it, which would detonate the thermite. Luckily, he gets the bomb out before, you know, he presses the button.
Mm-hmm.
Cold freezes his father, and therefore killing him.
Yep.
Damn, Snart.
Yeah. Cold as ice.
Yeah. Let's see here. Like we said, nothing really new with Patty. The only thing that happens is she gives Barry her number.
Yeah, the phone number.
And that was really awkward.
Yeah.
Like, it just... Like, I know that they were trying to make it awkward, but it was really awkward just watching it.
Yeah.
As well as, like...
Oh, so here's my number. Give me a call. Oh, you didn't want my number. You know,
yeah, it's just like...
Yeah.
Did we really need that scene? Did we really need her in this episode at all?
Yeah, she could have just been playing on the sidelines.
Yeah.
Know, for the little bit of time that she was in there, it made the scenes awkward.
Yeah.
I mean, if that's what they were trying to do, it worked, but...
Besides that, it's just...
Yeah.
They're no, kind of no
making
really.
Her like a bumbling...
Like, they're trying to make her like a Felicity, but with a cop.
Yeah.
And it's not working.
But Felicity's is... Cool though. I mean, you
well,
know,
what, her awkward moments are actually funny.
Yeah, these ones aren't.
Patty's awkward moments are just really awkward.
Yeah.
Oh,
it's, yeah. Well, like with Felicity, she has her little one-liners where she.
Yeah, where it's yeah. Like, you know, like the.
And that works because that's her personality.
Yeah, where it's like it's the cute. You yeah. know the internet's full of rage and hate. You know,
yeah.
little one-liners like that. That makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just like here. It's just like oh, that's. That's just too awkward. Like, what was the joke that she made about the guy, like, when they went to inspect the guy's head that was blown off?
Oh, yeah, that was the stepping on the ear thing.
Yeah, she steps on the ear and then says, like, did I just step on an ear? No. Oh, then I might have been hearing things.
Yeah.
And it's like, that is a terrible pun.
Yeah.
Like, really bad.
Yeah, they gotta work a little
bit. They gotta work on their writing.
Yeah.
Let's see here. Sisko gets a reward
yeah.
from Golden Glider.
Yeah, she's a cutie.
And then... Jay...
Is she in the comics, the Golden Glider, or no?
I can look it up.
Or is she just a made-up character for the show?
No, it seems like she's in the comics.
Oh, okay.
Yep.
All right.
See there.
Does she have powers?
I can look. Wikipedia.
I guess we should have did this before.
Yeah, it doesn't matter.
Okay.
Just make sure that the timer on the thing doesn't change. To, like, the new film thing. Because we've been having problems with that recently. Okay. Still haven't figured it out.
Should we pause?
Nah, we should be fine. It doesn't seem like it.
Here, abilities. She's an Olympic level figure skater.
She has flight in New 52, but New 52.
Okay.
Like, nothing really in New 52 has ever really worked, except for the Batgirl stuff.
So she's a skilled inventor of jewel-themed gadgets and weaponry.
Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Wears experimental skates.
But if you're going New 52, she has flight, ribbon-like the tentacle things.
Yeah.
Ability to move at extreme speeds, but yeah, New 52.
Okay.
So yeah.
Alright.
Side tangent. And then Jay Garrick gets the speed cannon, the thing that will stabilize the wormhole ready.
Yep.
They convince Jay to stay for their own different little reasons.
Yeah.
They're starting the whole relationship between Stein. I was looking here, and then that would have been weird. Between her and Jay. Do you mind covering him up again?
Okay.
I won't cut this out, but, you know, they convince, like, Jay to stay and everything like that. But it seems like they're starting a whole... What would we call it? What would we call their relationship name? You know what I mean?
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah.
Because they're trying to start that relationship.
I don't think it's going to last.
Jaitlin?
Though, yeah.
Would it be Jaitlin?
Yeah. I think whatchamacallit's coming back, though.
But
Bobby's going to be, right?
Robbie.
I think Robbie's in the other world. He's coming
back. Yeah, because the next scene is Stein turns into Firestorm for a quick second, but like a blue kind of Firestorm.
Yeah.
And was it black eyes?
They
started white and then they turned black.
Yeah.
So we have that, and then for a quick second, right at the end, Harrison Wells returns.
Yes.
Oh gosh, I don't know what to think. Is that normal Harrison Wells that we've been seeing in the little side scenes? Is that supposed to be Zoom?
I don't know if it's Zoom, but I think, you know,
because it would make sense. Because
I think Robbie and Wells got blown into the other world. And who's the speedster? The other speedster?
Jay.
And Jay and Zoom came into this one. So they're going back and forth that way.
Well, here's the thing with that is the Harrison Wells thing, I don't think that really works because we saw him die. We saw his corpse in this realm. I think they're just bringing in a Harrison Wells from Earth 2.
Oh, okay.
All right. So... your theory with Robbie could work since he was in the wormhole, but the whole thing with Wells probably doesn't work.
Yeah. But, I mean, when you have all these different realms, they're different worlds.
Yeah, it's hard to keep track of everything.
You know, so the Wells, you know, could from that world could have come into this one.
Mm-hmm. And, like, here's the thing, too. I wonder if he's Zoom, because if you think about it...
He could be.
He's pretty much the same as Reverse Flash so far. Yeah. Just a different costume. So, and also Wells would be smart enough to do stuff like that, like opening and closing the portal, getting people through and things like that. So, I don't know. I'm hoping that this Harrison Wells is just like Jay Garrick. I almost said Gay Jarek.
Oh.
That would have been weird. I hope that he is like Jay, where he is actually a good version.
Yeah.
Because it would be nice to see him kind of return to that role. And not in a wheelchair for once.
Yeah, I think the wheelchair thing's over and done with.
Yeah.
You know, that was just...
That was to shock
everybody for...
Yeah, I know. But I'm just saying.
Yeah.
Hopefully that's over and done with. And, yeah. I'm kind of excited about Harrison Wells coming back.
Yeah, he was a good character.
Yeah, great actor, too.
Mm-hmm.
So, I think that's it for Flash Talk this week. Not much to talk about in this episode. It was still a good episode.
I liked it.
It was still a really good episode.
The mom thing, I think...
Yeah, the mom thing and the Patty thing could have been left out, and it still would have worked.
Yeah.
It really didn't add anything.
Yeah, give more writing for Patty and then bring her back in as a real character, not a...
Not just like a...
Yeah.
Felicity ripoff.
I'm still in the show.
Yeah.
Make her part of the show.
Yeah. And
here's my number. That's not really...
Yeah, and like the other thing too with the, like I said, the whole crime scene thing. That was just like a little scene.
Yeah.
So, and again, nothing really to talk about there since they kind of confirm it in the next scene anyways. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, Flash was good this week. Flash, Season 2, Episode 4. It's a little weird... Starting off the show with Supergirl, even though like we're starting the whole show off with Flash, like recording-wise,
mm-hmm.
but it's just a little weird because I'm so used to just having kind of the pre-show kind of go into this, and well, we'll get used to it. We got several weeks of that. So, back on topic though, Season 2, Episode 4. A filler episode, definitely. This is definitely just filler.
Yeah, bringing all kinds of information into the series, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So we start off the episode 2 years ago with a bit of Barry's narration that he normally does.
Yeah.
With like special episodes kind of like this. Not necessarily like filler episodes, just like little episodes where like he's trying to hint towards something happening, but you know, stuff like that. And we see a football player named Jax.
Yeah.
Get hit by the particle accelerator.
Mm-hmm.
We then cut to present day where Team Flash is successfully saving Professor Stein from going into Blue Firestorm, and we learn that this is because Ronnie's not around anymore.
Correct. Yeah, there's nothing to bond for, you know,
for him to bond with. So therefore leading us to get into the second firestorm. And if you can't already get like the sense of what's going on here just from that those two opening scenes, then you're probably stupid. Because if you haven't figured out that Jax is going to be the final
firestorm,
we're like, not the final firestorm, but the second firestorm by now, with those two scenes, you could go, yep, that's why. That's the only reason why those two scenes would be played back to back. Which I wish they would have done differently. Because they gave it away way too early.
Yeah, well, they tried to leg it out with the third guy.
Which we'll get to, but it's like, here's the thing.
Because they found two people that had the same blood type, same...
Yeah, which is Jax and this other guy.
Yeah.
But the thing is, it's just... When you put these two scenes right next to each other, it's like, then what's the point?
Yeah.
I wish that maybe when, like, later on, you know, when they confront Jax, because that's the whole episode, is going to be Jax, you know, trying to become Firestorm. When he goes into his backstory later on, that's where they should have played this clip.
Yeah.
Instead of here, because then it would make more sense.
The whole Firestorm's whole... You know, I'm used to Johnny Storm, the whole thing.
Yeah, the flame on.
Flame on. I mean, that was so cool. I mean,
yeah.
Because I'm a Marvel fan. but with Jax, I mean, it's just, you know, Firestorm, it's just like his hands and his feet are like...
And his head.
And his head, it looks goofy because his clothes are still normal. They're not burning.
Well, that's like your problem with Firestorm. Like, he looks cooler in the comics because he actually has like a suit and everything. But
Maybe they'll... You know, Cisco will develop that down the road
and yeah.
make him a little bit look cooler or something. Because even, who's the other Firestorm?
Ronnie.
Yeah, even Ronnie looked kind of goofy not having a suit.
Okay, he looked weird when it came to the CGI scenes.
Yeah.
Besides that, he looked fine for me.
Yeah.
But moving on, we kind of got off topic.
All right, let's go. Sorry.
They have like a little Joe and Iris scene, right? Which, I love that little story that they told with the ice cream thing.
Yeah, that was
cool. I liked that.
Yeah.
And then we figure out that Iris is going to meet her mother.
Yeah.
All right?
I still don't see why. Yeah, I mean, I know why, but...
Yeah. It's, and again, we'll get into that. Yeah.
She could have just died and then, you got a brother. Why did they have to bring her in?
Oh, well, you just jumped straight to the end of the episode. Okay. Moving on... this is like...
Well, you can see it coming!
Yeah, you can.
You can see it coming!
You can.
Wes, come on! Sorry.
That's like your payback for me from last episode of Heroes Reborn.
Okay.
So, Patty is still going on about the number thing. I get it. She's supposed to be interested in him. She was like that in the comics
just
and things like that.
Kiss and get over with it.
No. Okay. But... I really don't want it to go this way. And I hope that this subsides quickly, since it's so painful to watch this kind of awkwardness.
It's dragging,
And here's the thing, too. They're trying to push this whole, Barry and Patty thing, whatever name you would come up with that for, Perry. Yeah. But, like, here's the thing. They're not together at all, anywhere in the comics. Anywhere.
Yeah.
She figures out, he has a thing for Iris, pretty quickly. And then, it's dead. They just stay friends, even though she's kind of interested in him. That's how it's supposed to go, and I hope that's the way they're going. But, like, the way that they're making it is, like, just throughout the episode, is, like, they're trying to push Barry towards it, Barry's trying to move towards it, and it's like, no, please don't. But the reason why I bring this scene up is because she finds some shark teeth, which kind of gives us a weekly villain, kind of.
Which next week is going to be cool.
Yeah, and it's King Shark. If you read the comics, you know who King Shark is. He's pretty much this huge humanoid shark, which looks really cool.
Excellent. Next week's going to be great.
Next week's going to be good. This week is, filler.
You put up
with it. We move back to Stein. He has a cane that will kind of stabilize him for now until they find the new partner, which we already went over. We see Wells in Star Labs, but then it cuts away quickly, so you can tell that he's gathering something there at Star Labs. They visit Jax. He doesn't want to be Firestorm. Iris meets her mother, and Iris pretty much tells her mother, "Fuck off."
Yeah. You've been out of my life for 23 years, I think she said.
Yeah, something like that. We don't want you here anymore.
Yeah.
Gone.
Yeah.
Which I love that scene. It's like, yeah!
You know?
But...
why bother now?
Yeah. Then after that scene, they meet the candidate for the other Firestorm. They try to merge into Firestorm. It doesn't work. Mercury Labs, where Snow used to work, and then they had the thing from last season, which I kind of forget.
The British woman.
Yeah. That laboratory.
Yep.
Is broken into by Harrison Wells.
Yep.
And then Patty and Joe know about the alternate Wells and decide to keep it a secret.
Yep.
Joe knows that it's an alternate Wells. Patty doesn't. She has no idea that this is another timeline type thing. That kind of stuff. Then we learn something interesting about Iris's mom. She has McGregor's and will die within a year. Good! Then I don't have to deal with her character that long.
Yeah.
Because I don't like her character.
Couple more episodes. Yeah.
I don't like her character.
Was she in the comics?
Probably.
Okay.
But like, yeah, I didn't like her character. She only has one purpose, which I think anyone could see from a mile away, is to bring in Wally West.
Yeah.
And if you were gonna kill her off anyways, then have her be dead. Have her be dead. Have Wally West show up and go, "Oh, I'm the brother that that you never knew of," or whatever his relationship with Iris and everything will be, according to the show. Well, you already spoiled it. Yeah, it's a brother. Wally's her brother.
Sorry.
And then, have it so he shows up. Mom passed away.
Yeah.
What do you mean, mom passed away? Oh, you didn't know?
Yeah.
I'm her son. And then they go on this whole thing of, why didn't you tell us, blah, 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 blah.
Yeah.
That kind of thing. I feel like they could have done that, and they wouldn't need Iris's mom, period.
Yeah.
It would have worked perfectly fine, but they had to drag it out a little bit. Moving on, Jack shows up at Star's Labs. Again, decides he doesn't want to be Firestorm. They try to get the other guy back. And I get that they're trying to keep Stein alive. But when the other guy didn't... he clearly didn't work.
No.
And now your other guy is saying, no, he doesn't want to. What makes you think going back to the other guy that didn't work in the first place was a good idea?
Yeah.
Little bit of idiotic writing there. Kind of pointless.
Yeah.
But I get it. They're trying to do anything to keep Stein alive. So, things like that. Next, Joe is trying to get Patty and Barry together. No one wants this. No one wants this.
Yeah.
So stop it.
Yeah. Everyone wants
Barry
and Iris to...
Barry and Iris, yeah. And then the other one is Snowberry, which is Caitlin Snow and Barry. That one I would be fine with. Not Patty. They're falling into the CW syndrome, which if you watch other CW shows, it would be the female male character meet for 4 episodes.
Yeah.
Or so, and then they fall in love.
Yeah, maybe she could hook up with Cisco or something. That might work.
Maybe, but like, that's how the CW works.
Although Cisco's got the one hot
Golden Glider.
Golden Glider.
But like I said, it's like they're falling into CW.
Hot Patty.
Well, yeah, definitely. They're falling into CW syndrome.
Not there's anything wrong with Patty, but
besides her character.
Yeah, we just don't understand why.
Don't get me wrong, like, the CW formula, it's clearly in this season. Where it's like, I'm surprised that they're even toning it down a little bit than the normal CW series, since I watched, like, the first 4 episodes of The 100, which was another CW series. It's a pretty good series. But I don't like how the formula is in that show either, because it's like, it's gonna be toned down for this show, definitely. But in that show, it's like, oh, first 2 episodes, they kind of meet. 2 episodes later, they're already having sex with one another, and it's like...
They hook up.
Yeah, and it's like...
And then 2 episodes later, they hate each other.
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, like, that's the CW formula, and I really didn't want this. If you were... Especially this way. build Patty's character, because her character is terrible right now. She's just a Felicity clone that doesn't work.
Yeah, she's definitely needs some better writing. We said this before.
Yeah, it's
she needs some better writing. She needs some character development. They're just not giving it to her, and basically they're filling up a slot for Joel's partner.
Yeah.
And then, Joe needs a partner. Well, let's throw this person in here.
Let's add a little bit of stuff into it and make it work.
But it's not working yet.
So. Yeah. Let's see here.
Make him a commissioner or something. Then that way.
Yeah. That way we don't.
He doesn't have a partner. He doesn't need one.
And here's the thing too. Just don't do the Patty Barry relationship. Did that ever cross your mind? Because that wasn't in the comics.
Yeah.
We could have totally went without that. Okay,
let's move on.
Yeah. We also get the other new weekly villain, which is the second Firestorm candidate, Hewitt.
Yeah.
So there's that. We've kind of figured out that he's turning to the dark side.
Yeah, he was kind of a lame villain.
He was.
Just...
Again, this episode's just kind of... Yeah.
Yeah.
Iris knows that her mother is dying.
Yeah.
Good. Firestorm candidate number two, which is Hewitt, finds Caitlin Snow and Jax when they try to get Jax back. And then he tries to kill both of them, but they both escape.
Yeah.
I like how, the fight between them is, literally pretty funny. Because here's the thing, right? You think about the fight. He's gathering all this energy, right?
Yeah.
Jax takes a wrench, throws it at his head.
Yeah,
he's knocked out for a minute. 1 minute, exactly.
Yep.
They get into their car, drive off.
Which is an electric car.
Well, And then
and he's drawing energy.
Yeah, and then here's
How the hell do you think the car started?
Well, here's the thing. The thing that I was, laughing at is just, they knock him out with a wrench, right? And then literally a minute later, he gets back up and starts draining more energy to fire at him again. It's like... What was the point of knocking him off then?
Yeah.
Just to save you a couple
times. It's a 12-volt battery in a car.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Sorry.
Jax merges with Stein.
Doesn't make sense.
Yeah. Jax merges with Stein to make him Firestorm 2. I always write down as Firestorm II.
Okay.
Whenever I for because that's how
hopefully they won't have 11 firestorms.
No, they won't. but that's how I always write it down, since it seems like comics kind of do it that way. Yeah. So when I say Firestorm 2, just know it's not the number 2. It's just II. Yeah. Let's see here. Hewitt attacks the high school where Jax used to play, where he had the accident.
Yeah, the college football
hero. And then we see Firestorm 2 in action along with the Flash.
Which was kind of lame.
It was lame. It's
totally stupid. Catch me if you can. They're playing the Firestorm.
Yeah, here's the thing. They're trying to piss him off, pretty much.
Yeah, so that he blows up and it just
It works, but it's okay, but it's really lame.
It would have been cool if he would have actually exploded. Kind of loses his temper and then Firestorm goes in there and hits him in the head.
Yeah, and here's the thing too. It's okay, I like the idea going into it, and I like some of the banter, but it was just anticlimactic. This is the only action you get this whole episode out of. This is 30 minutes into the episode.
Yeah.
No other action whatsoever, and you get a 5-minute fight, which literally involves a lot of running around him, and then one punch to the dome, and he's down.
Yeah.
You could have done that with the wrench!
Yeah. It was, pretty lame.
Yeah, very lame. Iris meets with her mother again, and we already said this, Wally West. Times.
Yeah, sorry.
Stein and Firestorm 2 leave, that way they can train, and then Stein tells Cisco to tell Barry and Caitlin about his ability.
Which he should have did that a long time ago. They're friends, right? You tell your friends your
problems,
you don't...
I kind of get it because of the whole Wells thing.
Yeah.
Because, everything that Wells did was dark
secrets.
And, twisted.
Yeah, keeping
so he doesn't want it to be, I'm going to turn dark and twisted now, since he's like, you're like a son to me. I give you these powers. And it's like, I don't want these powers because evil. I totally get it. Because it's like, the man that you trusted all your life gave you powers and you figured out that he's evil. You don't want to be him now that you have powers. Yeah. So, I understand it, but yeah, I think we should have had this talk earlier, maybe last episode.
Yeah.
Let's see here.
It's the whole, like, Darth Vader and Luke.
Yeah.
Yeah.
King Shark shows up at the end.
Which was cool.
He looks as good as Grodd.
Yeah, King Shark. Yeah, that was a cool... Yeah, he looked excellent.
Yeah. And then Barry knows that Wells is back, since Wells shoots King Shark. We don't know if King Shark is dead.
I think so.
He's just knocked out.
Yeah.
I hope that we get to see more of King Shark. Otherwise, it's totally pointless.
Yeah. You would think so, because it was the last 5 seconds of the thing.
Yeah.
So he's gonna, yeah.
So, and then that kind of concludes the episode. It's just, Barry's like, who are you? And he just pulls off the hood that he's wearing, and then it's like, oh, it's Harrison Wells.
Yeah.
We didn't see
it. But it could be a good Harrison Wells.
Yeah, we still don't know if Harrison Wells is good, bad, but it seems like he's kind of good since he saved Barry.
Yeah.
But we don't know if it's like Zoom.
Yeah.
We don't know if it's like Zoom or, you know, Harrison Wells is Zoom, Harrison Wells normal, Harrison Wells the bounty hunter,
yeah.
Whatever. You know, Harrison Wells the ice cream man that just happened to find really big guns.
Yeah.
No, but this is the weakest episode so far. It's not bad, but it's weak. Because it's a lot of filler that's just leading up to Firestorm 2 and Wally West, and the Patty moments are so frustrating because it feels like the CW formula. Let's see here. It maybe this would have worked better if it was paced out more.
Just stick with one thing.
Yeah.
You know?
Like, here's the thing.
Stick.
Have It So Firestorm was one of the first episodes of Legends of Tomorrow.
Or even if they would have just kept Firestorm for this whole episode and not even dealt with
Iris's mom.
And, you know.
Yeah. I feel like as soon as they...
And the whole Patty, you know.
Yeah, as soon as they entered the Patty... Or not Patty. The Iris's mom thing, I think they fell apart. They should have just cut Iris's mom out entirely.
Yeah.
And just have it so Wally shows up. I'm your son.
Yeah.
And my mom's dead.
Yeah.
That kind of thing.
They could have did it all with a letter.
A letter, something.
You know, I found this. My mom, you know, passed away and she gave me this before she
died. Do it at the funeral.
Yeah.
Do it at the funeral.
You know, you're not alone. You have a sister.
You
know, you have, you know, a dad.
Yeah. You know. Like, I feel like that would have worked perfectly fine. Yeah, some sort of letter, anything would have worked better than having Iris's mom in it, because it just draws it out way too much.
Yeah.
Firestorm, think this could have been one of the first episodes of Legends of Tomorrow. Could have been.
Yeah.
It would have worked. I'm fine with the Firestorm kind of origin, but it's just the Patty stuff and the Iris's mom stuff just really took away from it. Let's see here. I'm trying to see what else. We went over that. Also, where is Jay Garrick this episode? He didn't go home.
No.
He's nowhere to be seen in this episode.
Not in this episode at all.
And he didn't go home last episode, so that's really weird. I'm getting the feeling that the actor had the week off or something, but it just raises too many questions. To quote Batman Forever, it's just...
Yeah.
No.
Gosh. You know, I've been in two of the redhead girls.
Caitlin.
Why am I drawing a blank? Yeah, Caitlin kind of had the hats for him, and then now...
Now it's just like, yep. She's going back to, like, drinking, you know, oh, Ronnie. She's not actually drinking, but kind of like, you know that, like, typical movie scene where it's like, they're drinking, they have a picture of the one that they love, and they're just like...
Yeah. Well, I don't think she was that far.
You know.
Thing, but...
Yeah, it's not, like, that far, but it's just... To kind of compare it to something.
Maybe.
Compared to last episode, you know, where she was like...
Yeah.
Hi. She was
all flirty. And,
you know, and then now she's just like...
But she did look a lot hotter in this episode. I mean, she was wearing, like, makeup the whole time.
We are never going to get Danielle Panabaker on this show because of you now.
No.
Thank you so much.
I'm just saying, she looked really good this time. I mean, in this episode, she looked really good.
She looks great every episode.
I know. I'm not saying that she doesn't look good. I'm just saying she looked exceptionally good this time.
Yeah. How do you think they could have worked Patty better? Like, I think we've gone over it, but it's like, how would you wrote Patty?
Number one, I would still keep the Barry and Iris story that, you know, I'd keep that. And if they want to put them that, Joe needs a new partner, yeah, they could have a female partner.
Okay.
But put it in so that, and they're doing okay with, you know, like she's coming up with these clues and that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
It's just that they don't have to do a whole love interest right away. Let her get used to the group.
Yeah.
You know, and make her part of the team, not part of a relationship. I mean, dating, like, okay, physical, not everybody has to be paired up.
Yeah, you know? And here's the thing too. I don't think that they should have wrote her like Felicity. If they were going to do her whole personality thing,
yeah,
I would like to see her be like, because in the first episode, she was like dedicated to the cause and things like that.
Yeah.
And then kind of disappeared as soon as Barry walked in.
Felicity, though. I mean,
well, no, he's the male version of Felicity.
Yeah, but they don't need two Felicities on the show.
No.
And
what they should have done is have it so, like, she was the one that's, like, dead hard on the job.
Yeah.
Unless, the one that's always focused on the job. Sure, she may, like, look at Barry, like, a little differently. But, in, you know, that would be, like, the subtle kind of notice. But you don't have to go, like, can I get your number? Oh, that sounded weird. Yeah. That, didn't it? Oh, we've only been together for one episode.
Unless she's, like, the person that's always in the orange suit. The person in the orange suit always dies. So,
wait, don't you mean red shirts?
Oh, the red shirts. Oh, yeah.
Where did you get orange suit from?
I was close.
Are you thinking, like, you know, the Breaking Bad or something like that?
But the person always wearing the red shirt always dies.
In Star Trek.
So, in this thing here, you know, it's Joe's partner is always dying off. So, and maybe that's her point. To kind of get a little bit, you know, all of that, then, you know, they die.
Like I said, though, I think Patty would have worked if they made her die hard on the job. And then just have it so, like, you see her kind of break a little bit whenever Barry walks by and then just go straight back to it. Just kind of shake her head and go, yeah, look, we found this at the site. We don't know what it is. We're thinking it's a metahuman. We're thinking blah, blah, blah. And then just, like, have it so sometimes she just breaks a little bit, but that's it.
Yeah.
You don't have to go so Felicity on it that it doesn't work anymore.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just, this is the weak episode. This is the episode that's kind of has it so it falls apart a little bit. Next episode should be stronger, though.
Yeah.
Because hopefully that won't be filler because of Harrison Wells. Harrison Wells will save next episode. And if they happen to have more Iris Mom and Patty,
which I don't think they will
crap in there, it's like, just,
yeah. Hopefully they won't. Hopefully they'll just, you know, you have a brother and then the brother comes and says, hey, I'm looking for blah, 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 blah.
Yeah. But so
King Shark should be cool.
Shark should be cool. Harrison Wells should be awesome.
Yeah. So next week we're hoping double thumbs up. Back on track.
This one, it's like
you could skip this week and not really miss anything.
Yeah. That's totally the thing. It's just filler.
Yeah.
So Flash season 2 episode 5. This was a good episode.
I
really liked this episode, and I'll explain why. Excuse me. When we start off in Earth 2 at Star Labs, and we see that they were in development of a metahuman detecting device, and we learn that Wells created the metahumans on this Earth as well, and we figure out that Wells has a daughter and has a rivalry between him and Jay Garrick. So we kind of figure that out right off the bat. I love that. I love how they kind of jumped into that. You know, just kind of showing how different Harrison Wells is and seeing kind of that rivalry being set up and just kind of learning about the world just from that one scene is very good. We cut to modern times in this world where we see Wells from Earth 2. I'll just keep calling him Wells from now on because the other Wells is dead.
Yeah.
Meets up with the team back at Star Labs. And he has come to Earth 1 to help the Flash take down Zoom. Joe arrives, shoots at Wells, Barry stops him, and kind of explains what's going on. And we get another one of those really good Joe and Barry moments together. And I didn't know this, but him and Professor Stein were Broadway actors. So that explains why their drama is so good. Because they do this kind of thing constantly, just this huge drama. And they really make the show.
Yeah.
Mainly Joe makes the show really good.
Yeah, he's phenomenal.
He is a very good fatherly figure for Barry.
Yeah.
You know, don't get me wrong. Everyone else on the show does a great job. But whenever Joe and Barry have a scene like this, or Joe and Iris, or any time that Joe really needs to have a scene
heart-to-heart talk.
Yeah, you know. He's really good at that.
Yeah.
And
very believable.
Yeah, very... And even with Professor Stein, him and Sisko moments were very good too.
Yeah.
Maybe not as strong as the Joe and Iris and Barry moments, maybe because we see those more often than the Wells, or not Wells, the Stein and, you know, kind of Caitlin or Sisko moments. It's really cool to kind of just see that. And, like, with Joe's character.
Yeah. I get a kick out of Sisko. I mean, I don't think he's as good of an actor as the remaining cast, but I still love his character.
Oh, his character's great. It's like, he's just... Okay, he may not be... I don't think he's acting, and I think that's the difference. I think that a lot of his character is...
Is who he is.
Okay. Because that's how it just comes off. I don't know if that's the truth.
Yeah.
But that's how it always comes off to me. It's just, he's not really acting, so therefore, that's kind of why he's kind of the lesser actor.
Yeah.
He's just... That's just his personality.
Yeah, I think he plays his part great.
Yeah, he plays his part great.
And I get a kick out of him.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, as far as, like you say, having a Joe and Barry moment, I don't think he could do that with Sisko.
Yeah, not too well compared to everyone else.
I don't think it would pull off.
Again, still love...
Yeah, Sisko's great.
...character. I didn't like him at first, but he's
kind of... But he grows on you.
Yeah, he grows.
Because you didn't like him in the first season.
No.
And,
Season 2, he's, like, as soon as he started getting, like, the vibe powers, that's where I'm like, this is getting interesting.
Which, can we say that now?
No, not yet.
Okay,
not Save yet. It for the end of the
Save episode. It for the end.
Everyone at home is like, you just spoiled it. let's see here. Patty shows up and makes things awkward, like normal.
Yeah.
And they force the whole Perry relationship on it, and we kind of get another awkward scene with Sisko and this barista. I'll kind of spoil this early, but the Sisko and the barista thing was supposed to be awkward.
Yeah.
Patty and Barry was not. Just throwing that out there.
Yeah.
Anyways, Sisko gets a vision of a heist from a masked figure and informs Barry about it. Barry doesn't question this prediction and goes with it.
Yeah.
No, let's try this again. And I feel like this is the episode where I say this the most. No, let's try that again.
Yeah.
Barry questions Sisko about how he would know this information, and Sisko gets into a nice conversation with Barry about this, and he kind of explains this while the innocent people die.
Yeah.
That's like...
Yeah, that part was a little weird.
It was very weird. I feel like Barry should have questioned more.
Yeah.
And that, it's just, it works for the scene, it works for the episode, but it's just like one of those, no, let's try that again moments. Let's see here. Barry rushes to the bank, saves the hostages from the new weekly villain, which is Dr. Light. This is a very cool character. And here's the thing. It's different than the Dr. Light that we saw on the Teen Titans show. The one that's in the intro, that is, not the shitty Teen Titans Go. We get to see a female Dr. Light. Which is cool. I really like her costume. I really like...
Oh, the helmet was great.
The helmet was great.
The starlight coming out of her hands was done.
You saw the original Dr. Light, right?
No.
Okay, well, let me show you original Dr. Light. And you'll be laughing.
Because she was perfect.
Oh, so she was a female in... Oh, I don't remember her being a female in the Justice League cartoons. But that's what Dr. Light is supposed to be.
Oh, yeah. She's 10 times better.
Other costume.
Yeah, that's cool. See, yeah, that's her now.
Well, that's excellent. From the Justice League Unlimited, but...
Cool.
I knew male Dr. Light from the Teen Titans cartoon. I must have missed that episode.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I must have missed that episode of Justice League Unlimited where they had the female one, but it's really cool to kind of see that.
Oh, the hand, just, the, yeah,
yeah, just great. The character in general. I really thought that that character was one of those underrated villains.
Yeah.
From Teen Titans. It just seems like one of those B-list villains that works well in Teen Titans, and I love the Dr. Light character, and we get to see the Dr. Light character kind of a new spin on it in this episode, and it's a really good spin.
And
I really love that spin.
What's cool about it, maybe they could have done something a little further down, but in the first world, is it World 1 or World 2?
World 1.
In World 1, she never killed anybody.
Or Earth 1.
Earth 1. Yeah. You know,
well, in Earth 1.
She was a villain.
Well, that's Earth 2.
Or Earth 2.
Earth 2, she was a thief that didn't really kill anyone, just kind of used her powers to kind of, you know, do what Light does, blind people and things like that. That way she can get away and things like that. And we'll kind of get into everything else. And in Earth 1, well, you know how the show goes by now. If they're from Earth 2, they probably have an Earth 1 doppelganger. Yeah. Just saying. Wells and Jay argue about what Perry should do about Dr. Light. Which I can make a Mega Man joke there if I really wanted to.
Okay.
I was really looking forward to, like, the creation of Mega Man. You know, Dr. Light creating Mega Man in this episode, but it didn't happen. Wells says, attack Zoom. Jay says, wait it out and figure things out. Barry decides, we'll cross a road once we get there. You know, I'm going to try to take Light down. All right? Because that's the threat right now, not Zoom. We get another Patty scene, and we get that CW trope that I was talking about. Oh, we're 5 episodes in. Let's have a relationship that came out of nowhere.
Yeah.
So Barry asks Patty out. I don't approve of this at all. I really hate this trope with CW shows, and it's clearly made its way into The Flash. It's just, like, the whole Iris thing, that was understandable.
Right? Yeah, because that was...
Because, you know, that was years. This is like 4 weeks.
Yeah.
Right? And then even two of his last girlfriend in the other season, I didn't like her either. But I grew to kind of like that relationship that they had. Because they grew it.
Yeah. But there was always Iris in the background.
Yeah. And
so now Iris isn't even in the picture.
Yeah. And it's just... Wells figures out Cisco's secret about his powers.
Yeah.
Barry rushes to another Dr. Light attack. Barry tries to talk her out of this. You know, oh, you don't have to do this.
Yeah,
we'll help you against Zoom, blah, blah, blah.
Flash One tells her to talk her out of it.
He figures out that she's Linda Park, the old girlfriend. Then blinds him for 6 hours.
Yeah.
Who works with, Iris.
Iris, yeah.
And... good twist. I like that twist.
Mm-hmm.
Let's keep that twist. And, like, the thing is, too, that is a good move. That is a good move. I really like what the writers did there.
Yeah.
Great twist. Great idea.
And
the, and that works.
Mm-hmm. But the whole thing, though, can I get into this part yet, with Zoom? Why they have to take out?
Yeah, I guess you can say it.
Right? Okay, so... Zoom is sending all these people to World 1. What Earth are we? Earth 1?
We're Earth 1.
Okay, so Zoom is sending these people to
Earth 1. From Earth 2 to Earth 1.
Earth 1 to take out the...
The Flash.
No, not... But also...
Well, the main goal is the Flash, but in order for them to kind of stay there, they have to take out the other version of themselves. It's kind of like the idea of you can't have two of the same person within the same space kind of thing.
Yeah.
So that kind of plays in a little bit later, but you kind of see where it's going. If you know the Atom Smasher episode from the beginning of the season, you saw that he did the exact same thing. So it's kind of a thing. Like, if they want to stay in that realm, they have to kill the doppelganger. Dr. Light blinds Barry for 6 hours.
6 hours.
I'm not sure if I mentioned that.
Yeah, you did. And then they go on their blind date.
Yeah. And here's the thing that pisses me off
blind
so much.
Blind date.
Iris figures out that Patty is dating Barry, and she's perfectly fine with this.
Yeah. See, it's over and done with. Which, it's like, why?
Why?
Why does it have to be
over and done? Here's the thing, too. Whatever. Okay, this is something that's been bugging me ever since the end of season one. What are they doing with Gideon? Gideon's still in that room, just sitting there. They're not using Gideon at all.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, don't you think that they'd use Gideon more
often? Now, wouldn't he have somebody in Earth One?
Gideon?
Gideon?
Gideon's the computer program.
Oh. Okay, never mind.
That Barry creates in the future.
Yeah. Where is it?
It's still in that room. That secret room that Harrison was at. It's still sitting there.
No, but wouldn't that still be in Earth 2? The computer program?
No, it wouldn't be in Earth 2. Oh, I see what you mean.
Why wouldn't it be?
No. Because Wells didn't create it. Barry did. Barry created Gideon.
Barry created Gideon in
and
like
Gideon
the third
went back
world.
In time with Wells. Or Wells, I should say.
Okay.
So Gideon would probably still be here, even though that Reverse Flash Wells, we'll just go with that. Reverse Flash is dead. If you didn't see season one, oh well.
Okay.
You probably should have known this by now. So I think Gideon is still there because she was created by Barry, that kind of thing. I think that she's still there.
Okay. They just haven't.
They just haven't done anything with her or haven't confirmed that she's still there. And here's the thing with this blind date. It is so awkward and not funny.
And even Sisko doing all the stuff with the black and white, that was lame too.
It was terrible.
It was a terrible blind date.
And here's the thing too. Meanwhile,
not only that, right? It's a blind date. Sisko's talking him all the way through.
Yeah.
The game, and here's the high tech guy who only has black and white for
yeah.
And he can't even read the freaking wine list. Come on! You're supposed to be the super tech guy!
Yeah, it doesn't make
what
sense.
What the heck?
It was a terrible scene.
It was awful.
Yeah, it was just, I hate this
it's
so
black and
much.
White. And why wouldn't you be able to see the wine list if it's in black and white and you're filming in black and white? It would still be different shades of black and white. Sorry.
Yeah, it's just, that scene is just so cringeworthy.
It was horrible.
Because it's so bad,
it was
so awkward, it's so not funny, even though they intended it to be.
Yeah.
It's just, ugh.
Frustrating.
And here's the thing, too. Meanwhile, Caitlin and Jay are bonding with each other. And I would have loved to see this more than this Perry shit.
Yeah.
I'm quoting it, Perry now.
But I don't agree with those two bonding together, either. I don't know.
I accept that more than this whole Perry.
Yeah.
I would have liked to seen Byrus.
Yeah.
I'm terrible at coming up with
relationship
names.
Who would
Ronnie
be in Earth 2? Don't you think he
Firestorm.
Would be in there?
He'd probably still be Firestorm.
But why wouldn't she want to go back there then? Go back to Earth 2 with him to go meet Ronnie?
I don't know. Caitlin Snow in that universe. They confirmed it.
So.
With the photos. Yeah. Unless if she's supposed to turn into Killer Frost this season.
Okay.
I mean, at this point, it's been how long? Almost a year now?
Yeah.
You know, it makes a little bit more sense. Still, it is kind of frustrating. But it makes a little more sense.
Okay.
I don't think they should have done what they almost did with the kiss. They almost kissed.
Yeah.
I don't think I should have done that, but I really liked to see them kind of bonding because we figured out that Aquaman is in Earth 2. When he's talking about Atlantis, he's like,
oh yeah.
He's talking about Atlantis and he has a friend there and it's above water.
Oh yeah.
I was like, oh my god, Aquaman is in Earth 2.
They can't make a series out of Aquaman. That'll just be awful.
Yeah, Aquaman. Okay, here's the thing. Let's get into Aquaman real quick. Everyone says that Aquaman is terrible. And I believe that too. There's only been one Aquaman that I've ever liked. It's not the Super Friends Aquaman, because that's the one that everyone makes fun of.
Yeah.
The one from the Justice League cartoons with the hook hand, the trident, that Aquaman was awesome.
Okay, I didn't see it.
Trust me, that is a cartoon that I would sit
highly
you through.
Recommend.
I would sit you through and have you watch it because that was really.
We're good. Getting off topic now, though.
We can get off topic for an idea of an Aquaman CW show.
All right. Okay. Next.
I would like to see that. Anyways, Dr. Light attacks them, and then heads to Iris's work to kill her doppelganger. Their boss is accidentally killed when Jay shows up, and then Dr. Light disappears.
I don't think they had to do that. She didn't have to really kill him.
Yeah.
So, but anyhow, because she didn't kill anybody on her Earth, why would she kill anybody on this Earth?
It was an accident.
I know, but I'm just saying.
She was trying to kill her doppelganger, and then boom, and then total accident.
So, I just think it was unnecessary.
Harry isn't officially a thing. Once they kiss, you can start using that hashtag. And I hate every second of this. I hate every second that they're on screen together because it feels so forced.
Yeah.
We talked about this in the past that they never got together. They were never a thing. This is like the whole thing with his ex-girlfriend. She saw, wait, he has a thing for Iris. Shit, I have no way
no
of competing.
Yeah.
That was the thing.
Mm-hmm.
And they were more, that's what Patty should have been in this episode.
There was, and that was more accepted then, too. I mean,
I kind of went over it, but.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just, that is so annoying. We're getting it to the end here, so I'll try to wrap this up as quick as possible. Wells and Jay kind of duke it out, went back at Star Labs, Barry intervenes. Wells shares Cisco's secret to the group. Cisco tries to vibe the helmet, quote-unquote.
Yeah.
And it doesn't work at first, but Wells kind of forces him to kind of do it, and then they figure out the location. Wells is kind of a dick this season.
Yeah,
I kind of like that.
Yeah, he's kind of a knob.
But
he's very blunt.
Yeah, straight. I like how it's a different kind of Wells.
So who did I piss off in your world? Or,
that kind of thing.
How did I destroy your life?
Yeah,
you know, I'm not him, but it's like he's getting some enjoyment out of the frustration that he's wreaked havoc on everyone else's world.
Yeah, I like I said, I kind of like it that. Because it's kind of funny to kind of see the switch.
I'm not that person, but how did I ruin your life?
Yeah. But moving on.
Okay.
Barry creates the Speed Mirage to try to stop Light.
That was kind
of
cool.
And that is one of the coolest things that I saw this season.
That was pretty neat.
I really love that scene. They capture Light, and Jay decides to leave the group because everyone's kind of siding with Wells.
Yeah.
Cisco kind of gets a new love interest with that barista thing, and that's where I mentioned it was supposed to be awkward at first because she's like, I'm new in town, there's metahumans running around, I don't know what's going on,
mm-hmm.
Sorry, I was caught off guard. And then at the very end of this kind of episode, before kind of the last scene that we see, he decides to go with the name Vibe, which was his superhero comic book name.
Yeah.
Which I really like the name.
Yeah, it was cool.
I can't wait to see the costume that they have for him, if they give him a costume. And Harrison Wells is working with Flash, because Wells' daughter is captured by Zoom. And we get a really cool look of Zoom.
Yeah, that was...
Without the reverse Flash effect, where he's like...
The black, creepy...
It's like a really dark... Blue with kind of the scarecrow kind of version of the Flash mask, the inverted lightning bolt. Besides that, it's just a blue version of the Flash suit, but it looks so cool.
Uh-huh.
It's so awesome. This episode is awesome. I really love this episode.
It was good. Yep,
one of the best this season, I would say, except for the Patty and Barry moments. If you cut that out, replaced it with a Barry and Iris moment, it would have been one of the best episodes in Flash history. Flash, season 2, episode 6. Damn, Zoom is scary.
Yeah, Zoom's a good, good villain.
Very good villain. We got a very good look at him this episode. And
cool costume.
It's a very good episode. I really liked it.
I liked it. There's some flaws in it that I thought were just idiotic.
There's definitely flaws.
Yeah,
but it's very, very,
very
good.
Very good.
So, let's start off with the beginning. We start off with another Flash fight versus Dr. Light. Here we see Barry lose, and Dr. Light takes his Flash emblem away from him, throws it into the the kind of portal thing. Portal. And it looks like we just gotta go back to the red and the gold one.
Yeah.
But we jump back 72 hours before that, where Light explains why she's been working with Zoom, why she wanted to kill her counterparts, and then Barry explains that, you know, Dr. Light can help him defeat Zoom, you know, and that kind of thing. And the plan is that they have kind of set up with Dr. Light and thing, that kind of thing, is pretty much they're going to have him do what they did kind of at the beginning of the episode here. Take the emblem, throw it into the rift, have Zoom come for Barry, and then therefore setting off the trap. Mm-hmm. Caitlin and Cisco are very worried about this plan, while West and Wells were kind of fine with it. Mm-hmm. But then West kind of takes—I put it down as like takes the kids aside, you know. Yeah. But takes them aside and just goes, "I don't trust Wells. What I'm doing right here is giving him enough rope so that way he may hang himself," mm-hmm. Quote unquote there. Which, it makes sense.
Yeah.
It makes a lot of sense when you think about it. Then we kind of jump to Earth 2, where we see that Wells is talking to his daughter, Jesse, somewhere around there.
Yeah.
And here, like, we see that Jess is kind of upset that she was never told by her father that he was the one that created all these metahumans and things like that. And then she kind of gets pissed at him and then walks out.
Yeah, I've learned enough today or something like that.
So. Because she kind of skipped a day of college.
Skipped a day of college. I learned more, yeah.
Yeah, and like she was like one of those kids that graduated high school at like 15.
Yeah.
So they prove that she's very smart as well, like her father and things like that. So I think that's where that kind of line popped in. Back at the Earth 1 police station, Patty tries to give Joe a science lesson about light. That way... You know, they could use it for the Dr. Light case.
Yeah.
Well, Joe shoots her down.
That she could turn invisible.
Yeah.
And then,
And then Joe kind of shoots her.
Later.
Yeah. Kind of shoots her down. Then she meets up with Barry and, I'm never going to like any of this. This Perry relationship, I'm not going to like it one bit. And for those at home that are wondering what I mean by Perry relationship... Take Patty, right? P-A.
Yeah.
And then put the last part of Barry in there. A-R-R-Y. Perry. Yeah. It's just... Oh, it's so frustrating. I never understood why they did that. She was never really a thing in the comics.
Yeah.
It's just... Anyways.
Anyhow.
At the news station, Iris kind of talks with Linda... And Linda wants to help out the Flash in some sort of way. Linda is the Dr. Light doppelganger, in case you didn't remember her from season one. Let's see here. Speaking about Dr. Light, she escapes through manipulating light around her to make her invisible. Yeah. Like Patty was saying
like
earlier.
Like Patty was saying earlier.
And now we don't know where she is.
Missing in action.
I think it's safe to say that they never say it in the episode where she is.
No, she's all we know is just that invisible with no clothes
gone.
On.
Yeah. Well, that's one way to escape.
Zoom. Well, didn't it look like her outfit was on the floor?
Well, that was her outfit on the
floor.
Yeah,
so she's naked.
Yeah, it's just when you say it like that, it's like oh.
Okay. Saying it like it is.
Yeah.
Streaking.
Anyways, Barry asks about the speed dampener dampener
that
Wells was kind of creating. It's kind of like some sort of antidote type thing for a little bit, where it just lowers the speed that they can go at and things like that. They say that it's not quite ready yet, and they think that that will help in slowing down Zoom to kind of Barry's level, since... From what they hear, Zoom is far above him, and we get to see that later on.
Yeah.
So, let's see here. Joe kind of talks to Barry and tries to tell him to slow down, that he's trying to rush, you know, taking on Zoom and things like that, but Barry isn't taking it. And he kind of has a good reason for it, but Joe has the better reason on why he shouldn't do it. I know you were kind of mad at that.
He's rushing, yeah. I think... Yeah,
it works in the long run of this episode. It's not like Heroes Reborn where it's just...
It's like when you take on anything, you have to know who you're going against. Like, whether it's sports or
you know, a chess game or Risk or, you know what I mean? You have to know how your player works and how it would all, you know.
Yeah.
You just don't go in there blindly and to figure you're going to, you know, kick some ass. It just, it doesn't, sometimes you get lucky, but 9 times out of 10.
Yeah. And like I said, I understand why you didn't like it, but I feel like it kind of works. His reasoning kind of works, but yet it works very well. Like, just at the beginning of the episode, it kind of works, but then they explain it a little bit more throughout the episode, and then you kind of see, yeah, it starts to work, and then you see...
Yeah, total chaos.
Yeah. Let's see here. Sisko tries to vibe Wells for the first time, but Wells is kind of too smart for that. We get another flashback, though, not from the vibe, but just of Wells in general. And we learn that Ollie in this universe was the one that died, and then his father became Green Arrow.
Oh.
That was a little hidden thing in the kind of newsreel that they had.
Oh, I didn't catch that.
It was Robert, the Queen, that survived, and not Oliver Queen.
Oh.
Therefore, multiverse, and then okay. they said that he came out and he said, "I am Nero," in that universe. So, kind of think like Thomas Wayne from Earth 2, for my Batman fans that read Elseworld World comics out there, but mix that with Iron Man's I don't care kind of personality. There you go. But we also learned that, kind of what we learned before, Zoom has Jess.
Yeah.
Back at the police station, Patty tries to talking to Joe.
Yeah,
and boy, did I think that the Barry and Patty sequences were awkward. Yeah, just kill this character. I mean, she's not working at all the way that you're writing her or rewrite her.
And even in real life.
That doesn't work.
That doesn't work. People keep their personal shit aside and, you know.
Yeah, it's just, oh, she's nobody so... Nobody needs
to know, I mean, in order to work side by side with somebody, they don't need to know that. Yeah, it's just...
Yeah, it's
what you do in your extracurricular activities. It's just, you get your job done. And,
yeah, and, like, Patty, her writing is terrible. Everyone else's writing is still great. Hers is terrible. It's like, they were told by the CW, oh, you need a love interest this season. You need a love interest this season. You can't use Iris again. You need a love interest this season. Hey, can you hear me? You need a love interest. And then the guys writing Flash are like, okay, Mom!
You know,
you know, just kind of doing that, like, you know, when your mom is nagging you for stuff and then you're just, like, about to explode because of it. It's just like, that's pretty much the whole writing for Patty this whole time. It's just, let's just do it.
Unnecessary.
Because we're told to do it.
Yeah.
Moving on. Iris and Barry are back at the house. Barry gets the idea about Linda kind of taking over as Dr. Light.
Yeah, I don't get that. Using, that was stupid.
Well, it does make a little sense. It does kind of work.
Yeah, but I mean, that would have taken, you know,
months. Oh, yeah. But
in, you know, not 3 days.
But like we said, that's kind of the whole premise of this episode, and that's the whole kind of Barry thing is...
He's rushing.
They're showing that he's trying to do something. Yeah. He just doesn't know how to do it. But the idea is to put Linda in the Dr. Light costume, have her kind of drag out this whole scheme. Excuse me, this whole scheme with Dr. Light, you know, and Barry, and kind of doing that thing with the original plan from the beginning. And Linda agrees to help. They train Linda, and it is it is hysterical,
you know.
Because they have the cutouts of Sisko and Joe and Caitlin and the Flash, and she's like missing the Flash ones like that she's supposed to be hitting, and then, you know, we get like three really good clips there where Joe is like, oh man, what
this
was
isn't
it
gonna work?
No, it was like, Sisko, what does a bad idea look like to you?
Oh,
Who was the one that came up with this horrible idea? And then Sisko is just like, Hey, I'm trying to look at the positive side here, okay? I'm trying to be positive, so let's stay positive, yeah. People.
It was cool that he recreated her.
Yeah, it was very cool.
That was really cool. Sisko's a genius.
Yeah, Sisko really pulls through in this episode. He really makes this technology really cool.
Wait, I gotta
cool.
tweak that. You know.
Yeah, and like all of, this whole scene is just, it's hysterical, it's cool, it's a great montage.
Yeah.
I really loved this. We get another good moment here between Joe and Barry, and this is where he kind of explains it a little bit more, that he kind of feels empty. He yeah. feels empty because he wasn't the one that defeated Reverse Flash. Eddie did, which yeah. Eddie was the ancestor to Flash, or Reverse Flash, so therefore he had to kill himself in order to, you know, save the world, blah, blah, blah. And that's where Barry was like, I should have been the one.
Yeah.
He feels like I should have been the one. I should have did it without, you know, Eddie having to sacrifice himself, blah, 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 yada, yada, yada. And that I can understand. That I yeah. think is actually a good, it's a good reason behind all this.
Yeah.
And it works very well. But the way that he goes about it will bite him in the ass pretty yeah. soon. And here's something that doesn't work, period. Barry reveals himself to Linda.
Yeah, that doesn't make
Why?
Any sense whatsoever.
Why?
All he had to say was, I'm the Flash. I'm, you know, I believe in you. He doesn't have to, you know. Yeah.
Just, why? This is like one of those Arrow moments yeah. where it didn't make sense in Arrow and it doesn't make sense here. I mean, I'm assuming these are the writers from season 3 of Arrow. Did he do this a lot?
In Arrow?
In season 3 of Arrow, where it's like, yeah, why did he reveal himself?
Yeah, every episode he was revealed.
But that wasn't season 3, though, was it?
I think that was season 2. Season 1 and season 2, he was constantly revealing himself.
Maybe they got the season 1 writers.
Yeah, I don't know.
For Arrow. Or had a couple of them still lying around.
There is no reason to...
There's
he
no...
shouldn't have been in it to begin with. You know what I mean?
Well, okay, the plan does make sense.
Yeah, yeah.
The plan does make sense.
They could have gotten anybody. To
no, they
put
could
the outfit on.
No, they couldn't have gotten anyone. Zoom would have noticed.
Yeah.
The doppelganger was the best idea that they had in order to kind of, you know, make it seem legit. They were trying to make it as yeah. legit as possible. Therefore, she was the best idea. Did I think that they rushed it? Of yeah. course. But it was a good idea. It was a good plan, going into it.
Yeah. It just had disaster written all over it.
Yeah. But, like, again, I don't understand why they revealed...
You know, 3 months of training.
You know,
yeah. But...
I don't get it. I don't get why. This... Logic? Logic, people?
Ugh. 2 days? No.
No. Back at Star Labs, Sisko tries the vibes wells again. This time he's successful, and then we see that Jess is captured, and we see why Wells is such a dick.
Yeah.
Back at the police station, Patty tries to figure out why Joe is hiding the light case from her, and she pulls out the "You don't trust me" card.
Yeah.
No shit. He's only known you for a couple of episodes, and you've already pulled the CW trope yeah. with Barry on him. Of course, he's not gonna trust you.
Yeah.
There's no way he's gonna trust you. Anyways. Linda and the Flash kind of play out their routine, which is, it's awkward, but it's actually kind of funny, unlike yeah. most of Patty's lines.
But the whole thing where she misses, and then he still falls down.
Yeah, it's still funny.
You know, if he was there and watching this, he would have known right away this is...
Yeah, and that's why he never showed up.
Yeah, it's like,
okay. The dialogue in this scene, in the comedy
scene... laying
there
for an hour.
Yeah, like, the dialogue in the scene is, like, it's not... Okay, it's better than Patty's, but it's not as good as Felicity's.
Yeah.
I really like the comedy here, and I really like the one-line kind of jokes that they throw in here. But anyways, Linda kind of throws the emblem into the rift, and like you said, he doesn't show up for about an hour. Then Joe and Barry have another moment, which explains the point even more.
Yeah.
Patty and Barry, skip.
Yep.
That's literally how I wrote it, too.
Yeah.
Iris and Linda have a little bit of a girl moment before Zoom finds her and takes her. Zoom heads to the roof of Star Labs and kind of wants Barry to kind of prove himself to Zoom.
Yeah.
by dropping cool. Linda off the roof. And this cool. is one of the most awesome scenes in Flash history, I think.
Yeah.
Because the dialogue, the part where Zoom catches the lightning bolt that Barry throws at him and throws it right back at him is amazing. The verticality, or the vertical velocity CGI where they're falling in midair and fighting, beautiful.
Yeah.
And
it just, I still think, and you disagree with me, but I still think Wells would have known that he was able to do that.
Yeah, okay. So the argument is that we've been having off camera is that Wells would have known that the lightning bolt wouldn't have worked on him.
Yeah.
Wouldn't have worked on Zoom. And the thing that I was going to say was that Wells does not know that Barry had the capability of doing that. And your argument to that is, well, once he saw him starting to do it, why didn't he say, no, stop.
Yeah.
And the reason why is, I think it's just in shock. I think, you know, he's so in shock that he's like, kind of thing.
Yeah, see, but, I mean, if he's seen all these fights before, and he's commenting on how to do it, well, no, because he didn't do it with the other guy.
Yeah.
So.
I mean, like, I don't think he's seen every battle against the Reverse Flash, Zoom. I don't think he's seen every Jay Garrick in his fight, and I think that he kind of overestimated Barry, and that's why he thought, oh, it's going to work. Because he thinks that Barry was faster than Jay Garrick, that he was smarter than Jay Garrick, and then here we get to see just everything fall apart for Barry.
Yeah.
You know, just that lightning trick, gone.
Yeah.
Pretty much, he snaps
his vertebrae.
Then he starts carrying him around, right, to the news station, then to the police station.
And he's just hanging there bleeding.
Yeah, and then back to
Star Labs.
And you just see Barry's bleeding. Yeah. He's like barely holding on. I think Zoom has him by the neck, showing him around, by the top of the thing. And it's just, oh, God, in Zoom's dialogue, and Barry's dialogue, this is one of those scenes
very well done.
Where it's like, yes, this is where you show Zoom as the monster that he is.
Yeah.
That the villain of this season is twice as bad as Reverse Flash, and that he's so well put together.
Yeah, he looks really cool.
He looks like a mixture between Scarecrow, Flash, and maybe someone who was wearing a blue shirt that day.
He almost looks like Venom, but with the Flash
emblems. I see more Scarecrow, mainly because of the mouth. But, like, he really is, like, kind of like a bluish Venom mixed, you know, where, like, it looks black, but it's more blue.
Yeah.
Mixed with Scarecrow and mixed with Reverse Flash. And it's just, that's terrifying.
Yeah.
And I love how terrifying he is. But Zoom gets cocky, tries to kill Barry, but Cisco kind of shoots him with a speed dampener. He runs out and escapes, leaving Barry behind. Joan Wells kind of get into it a little bit because, you know, it's like, you know, oh, so because, like, they kind of figure out the daughter thing and things like that. He's like, oh, so Zoom sent you here that way you can kill Barry, blah, blah, blah. And, like, a lot of, like... it's not a lot of it, but it was like one really hard push where I was like, oh, you know, where that, it just, oh, it works so well. But I just had to restart the thing. Sorry about that. But it's like, it's just that tension there between Joe and Wells, just for even though it's a split second screen.
Well, because I mean, it's like,
well put
feels
together.
Like he's and, responsible.
You know, like they're yelling at each other too.
Yeah.
And it's just like, you know, that's really good. And then, like, Cisco, like we said, kind of tells, you know, about Wells' daughter and things like that. And then he confirms that Jess is still alive for Wells, which is really kind of reassuring for Wells.
Mm-hmm.
And then Barry wakes up and he can't feel his legs. And that's where they ended the episode. Yeah. And I'm like, oh my gosh, this is amazing. Now, I feel like that's going to be kind of fixed. Because if you remember correctly, they said that he still had the fast healing. His speed wasn't gone or anything. His fast healing's still there. So I feel like he'll be out of it for maybe a couple episodes. But, you know, and it's just going to be kind of like setting up maybe
Yeah, he's got to walk all over again.
Kid Flash or something like that. I feel like that's probably where we'll go next is the Kid Flash saga with Wally West. And then, you know, you kind of see that Barry is kind of tutoring him in kind of like a Yoda style where he's just like, you know, maybe in Wells's wheelchair because that's the only one that they have.
Yeah.
He's just kind of mentoring him and things like that. I feel like that's where they'll go next. But I don't know. I feel like he's going to regenerate, but I feel like it's going to take a couple episodes, and I don't know what they're going to throw in for the filler episodes. Because if you missed last week's show, I have a theory where the theory is that they have 9 episodes a season for filler, 13 episodes for the main story. And I feel like that's maybe what the next 2 episodes, next 3 episodes will be filler for Kid Flash. Maybe a Legends of Tomorrow with Cold and his brother, and maybe one other, you know, kind of scene. But I feel like, or like one other episode. But I feel like this is where everything's gonna happen, and maybe this is gonna be the episode, like next week, where Jay comes back because Jay wasn't in this episode. He kind of left. An episode or two ago
to do some training. Yeah, whatever.
You know, and I think, you know, like this may be the episode where he comes back and he's like, I told you so.
Yeah.
You know, and then I'm excited to see where they go with this next week.
Yeah. Well, the thing is now, Zoom knows where their headquarters is. He can just come, you know, technically he could just come back and finish it.
Yeah.
I don't know. You never know.
But same with Reverse Flash.
Yeah.
You know. But I feel like they're going to play this kind of waiting game, this kind of, this game where it's like, yes, I know all about you, Barry.
Yeah.
But I'm going to watch you suffer first.
Yeah.
And I feel like that's where the next 3 episodes are going to be.
Underneath the magnifying glass.
Yeah. So, like I said, amazing episode. It's very well crafted, very well put together. The worst parts are the Barry part, like Barry and Patty, Perry kind of thing.
Yeah.
And the part where he told Linda about it. I still liked Linda kind of trying to be her other persona. I still liked that, even though it is kind of awkward to see her in the final fight, but it was a good setup for comedy, and I really liked that because
The part I didn't like about that is when Linda said, I made out with the Flash. I thought that was kind of funny.
It was a little funny, but it was one of those, really?
Yeah, I mean, I didn't, there's no reason to tell her.
There's no reason to tell her.
But I still got a kick out of the...
A little bit, yeah.
Yeah, that she said she made out with the Flash.
Yeah, so Flash, Season 2, Episode 7, officially the 1/3 mark. So...
Yeah, I'm digging it.
I'm digging it, too. I'm really liking it. So, let's just jump right into it, then. We start off the episode with Barry kind of walking around on a cane before he kind of takes, like, 6 steps and then just collapses into Wells' old wheelchair.
Yeah.
He is almost completely healed due to his healing factor, but not entirely.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, that too. But at the beginning of the episode, he's not near full strength at, you know.
Yeah, he can't do the burst of speed.
Yeah. While Barry is down and out, Wells wants to return home to face Zoom head on. Everyone kind of accepts this, except for Caitlin. Not really sure why, but it works for the episode.
Yeah.
We get another awkward Barry and Patty call, but it's not as awkward as some of the other ones, so maybe her writing's getting a little better.
I think her writing's getting a little better. She's not as annoying.
Yeah. Then after that, Caitlin meets with Wells, and Wells creates a new plan from that little meeting that they had, and the new plan is to close all the breaches except for the one at Star Labs. That way they can trap Zoom when he runs through the last breach.
Yeah.
Sisko goes on his date with the barista, which he kind of accidentally vibes her, and we figure out that that's Hawk Girl.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Which, pretty good casting, I'd say.
Yeah.
I didn't know who she was going to be.
Mm-hmm.
I only saw the costume and everything. Not bad casting.
Yeah.
The
costume looks really cool too.
Yeah. Yeah, I really like the costume and how it kind of looked. You get a better view later on in the episode.
Yeah, but from the second shot.
Yeah, but the first shot It's more of kind of like the back, like showing off the wings and everything, which looked amazing. Yeah, because
he needs a man.
Yeah, at first.
At first, yeah.
But there is a Hawkman in the series, so maybe we just were looking at it wrong. Maybe it is.
The first one was Hawkman, and the second one
was Hawkgirl. Hawkgirl. But I think both of them were Hawkgirl. I don't know. At the science lab, we see that someone has taken over the minds of one of the scientists, and he stole something for the great Gorilla Grodd.
I love Grodd.
Grodd is amazing. The police show up the next day to kind of see what happened there.
Mm-hmm.
But back at Star Labs, we see that Joe is kind of pushing Barry a little too far, and we see that Zoom broke him in more ways than one.
Yeah.
Because his confidence is totally destroyed because of Zoom, which is kind of affecting his recovery as well.
Which I think that's what happened to the first Flash.
Jay.
His confidence is totally shot.
Yeah. Yeah. So, and that's why... I mean,
you could see that happening with Barry here. Yeah. So.
That's a good parallel. I never thought about that. Maybe once Jay comes back into the series, because he's got to come back in.
I would think so.
You know... We got to see the two speedsters trying to take down the one. It's like...
Yeah.
Or three, because they said that Kid Flash is supposed to be in this season. So, three speedsters against the one, that would be really cool.
Yeah.
Plus, if they surprise us with any more speedsters, that would be amazing. Let's see here. Meanwhile, Caitlin falls underneath Grodd's spell, punches Cisco out, which I thought that was cool. Funny.
Yeah.
and then Joe kind of figures out that... Grodd has returned and has captured Caitlin. We then see where Grodd has kind of taken her, and we see that the CGI for Grodd just keeps getting better.
Oh, yeah, that's amazing.
I really love that CGI. I don't know what their budget is to kind of pull that off, because it looks... It's not like, okay, Planet of the Apes realistic or anything like that. But it looks... Like, it's there, almost.
Yeah, it's...
You can tell that it's a little bit CGI'd, but it seems like the way that the actors kind of interact with it, it feels like it's there.
Mm-hmm.
So, I don't know if that's just them being really good actors.
It's just well done.
Yeah, it's just well done on everyone's part there.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason why Grodd took her was to create more of Grodd.
Yep.
More
intelligent apes.
Yep. We see that Barry is getting some of his speed back, but his dad visits him, not Joe, but his actual dad, visits him, and we see,
forensics guy either. I didn't know that.
He was a doctor.
Yeah, I thought his dad was just a cop, like.
No, he was a doctor. I think they made that, clear
they probably
in the
did. I just
first
didn't.
Episode
yeah.
of the season, but it's been so long since then, so.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, Cisco fills Wells in on how old Wells created Grodd, and Wells, wow, a lot of Wells in that sense, found a way to find where Grodd is hiding through some sort of algorithm.
Yeah, you know what, I kind of think that he already knew that. I kind of think that in Earth 2...
He had something to do with Grodd as well.
He had something to do with Grodd as well, because when we get to the next, or later on, at the end of the series, I'll say my thing.
All right. Let's see here. There's three potential locations for where Grodd is, and Wells is going to try to use the Reverse Flash suit to try to trick Grodd into thinking that it's
him.
Old Wells.
Yeah.
Which we get kind of a really interesting scene with Barry's dad and Wells.
Yeah.
Because, you know, he sees Wells in the Reverse Flash suit. And we just kind of get an interesting moment there where I wish it would have been like...
Well, that was the first time Barry actually used his speed when he saw Wells in the Reverse Flash suit, because he just darted right to him, threw him up against the wall.
Oh, I didn't know.
And he didn't... Prior to that, he didn't have his speed. You know, he was only going a little bit on the treadmill.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and all of a sudden he sees Reverse Flash and BAM!
Yeah.
You know, it just kicked...
Wait, was it Barry or was it his dad? I thought it was his dad.
No, Barry.
That was Barry?
Hitting him up against the wall.
Man. See, I watched this like, I just watched Arrow, and then I watched that right before it.
Yeah.
So, my mind's a little foggy on that, but... Yeah, I guess you were right on that. Anyways, Barry and his father kind of get a great moment with one another.
Mm-hmm.
It's just the like family moments in the show are amazing.
Mm-hmm.
I gotta reiterate.
They're very
that.
Well. Yeah, they're
very well written. They got the right actors to do it.
It's like they're it's like real family.
Yeah,
they must be real close in real life.
Mm-hmm. And then we cut to Caitlin and Grodd, and then they kind of fall into Wells' new trap. Grodd catches on to Wells, though, because I think it was, Wells was asking, not taking.
Yeah, telling him. He was asking him for something and not telling him to do something.
Yeah. So. And they escape, and then Wells is actually the one that did the most stuff during this part, because
mm-hmm.
Barry was more taking the Wells role, which I thought was kind of cool.
Yeah.
Kind of seeing the reverse, see what I did there, of what normally happens in the show. And he's the one that takes the drugs that Grodd was stealing to try to create these new meta apes.
Yeah.
And just...
Overdoses
him, with them. Back at Star Labs, they debate whether or not they should kill Grodd or just capture him or whatever. But they do come up with a plan, and the plan is to get Grodd through one of the breaches, to bring him to, a kind of piece of Earth 2 that is similar to what he wants.
Uh-huh.
Where
the apes roam free or whatever.
Yeah. The following scene is very well done. The following kind of fight scene, it's not really a fight, but, kind of... That's the thing that I've been noticing about Flash a little bit too, is it's not like Arrow fights or anything like that. I barely see Flash actually throwing punches or anything. He's just tactically outmaneuvering people.
Yeah.
Which I really like that. So they have a really good scene there. The only bad part about it is we won't see Grodd for a while.
Okay. I think we're to the point now. Wells,
mm-hmm.
right? Wells knows where to drop him off.
Yeah.
I mean, knows exactly where, what portal. How would he know all that stuff if he didn't have any insight to Grodd already? You know what I mean? So he knows that there's this city full of, these apes and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Advanced.
Okay, the way that I can kind of predict it is he was looking at that map for all the this was during that bar scene.
Yeah.
He was looking at the map where all the rifts are and trying to pinpoint which one was Zoom's.
Yeah.
Compared to on his world. So he must have known about the rifts when they were opening up on his world, or, during those episodes where we didn't see Wells.
Yeah.
He must have been... studying them there, figuring out where they are in his world, and now he's trying to match them up with
where they are in our world.
Yeah. So I think that's how he figured that out.
Yeah.
It's just he's been planning this for a while, when he wasn't seen in the Flash, and now he's using his knowledge from that planning to get at Zoom here. So that's what I'm kind of thinking. Back at Star Labs, they figure out that Barry could possibly use the same ring technology that the Reverse Flash used, which was pretty cool. And here's the thing, too. I don't like how they're like, oh, we should destroy the Reverse Flash costume. And I'm like, if you think about Kid Flash's costume, right? The yellow and the red, it would work for his costume. Flip I think the emblem is upside down on the Reverse Flash. Flip it so it's right side up. Give him a different looking domino mask. There you go. You have the Kid Flash costume. You're good. just reuse it. Reuse it for
better.
Yeah. Well, we don't know. We don't know what Kid Flash will look like. So, if Kid Flash looks like his new 52 counterpart, where it's like silver and red, I'm gonna go no. If it's yellow and red like the classic, then yes. It's just I don't like the new 52. Kid Flash look. But anyways, they also kind of learned that Grodd was sent to a refuge for gorillas that were experimented on.
Mm-hmm.
And I got a little theory about that, so I'll try to finish up these notes real quick here. We get to see another Barry and his father moment, followed by a nice bonding moment between Iris and her father, yeah. which I liked. We get a Perry and Ben, or that can't speak. Yeah. Barry and Patty moment again. But hey, at least we get a pretty cool Cisco and Hot Girl moment, and then, you know, we get that second view at that, yeah. the Hot Girl costume.
I love the whole Princess Bride is the perfect date.
Yeah, it is pretty true.
That was great.
But we end the episode with Grodd looking over his new home, and he doesn't look too pleased.
Yeah.
And, okay, my theory, because this was from, like, a Justice League game that I played a long time ago when I was a kid. Remember Justice League Heroes, the one that lets you play around as all the DC superheroes?
Okay, yeah.
Remember the one level in there where you were in Grodd's kingdom, where he had all his gorilla foot soldiers? I think that's where they're going.
Yeah, so he's going there to
control every yeah. single one of them, and then get back to Earth One with that army. With I think that's where we're gonna be
see,
going.
See, season I thought three, Wells was like or, part of that.
No. Wells would not be part of that.
I didn't know if Wells was in the comics or he was working with Grodd.
I can check to see if Harrison Wells is in the comics.
To create a guerrilla army.
Comics. Yep. It looks like he is. Harrison Wells, DC Comic Database. Flash. Nope.
Okay.
It doesn't look like he was.
All right.
Yeah. It looks like he was created just for the show.
Okay.
Never mind. But even if like they had some sort of character that was, you know, like Reverse Flash, that I don't think that they would have meshed it with Grodd. I think Grodd would have been, you know, very independent. Like, they needed to set up Grodd that way, but now Grodd, I feel like, is becoming his own villain. He's feeling kind of betrayed by the people that were close to him now. Now he's gonna, you know, control his own kind, yeah. manipulate, kind of like Reverse Flash did.
Because he said we were going to take the city together, remember?
Yeah.
So that's why I thought maybe that they had something.
Well, remember too, like, he was trying to channel other Wells. Okay. They had a little bit of a funny scene with that too, where they're like, well, he's like, why do I have to channel old Wells? Because he's going to figure it out, and we don't want to risk it. And, you know, he just says, like, the, you know, you're like a son to me, Cisco. And he's like, no. Yeah. Try upping the creepy factor just a little bit. And then he does it, and then, you know. So I feel like they would have kind of informed him on everything that he was kind of planning with Grodd, because they kind of knew that in season one, or at least I think they did. So I think that was a lot of that, was a lot of planning towards that. And then, you know, just kind of having him, like, look over the notes and go, yep, okay, got it, you know, that kind of stuff. So, again, very good episode.
Yeah.
Kind of sad that we won't see Grodd for a while, but hopefully, if he does get another episode, I'm assuming it's going to be season three. Bring the army of gorillas, please. I want to see that. Don't just have it be like, this is the end of Grodd.